one misstep, and we fall to our ruin. So take your first step. It's now or never! I will return here someday, my teacher. Promise me that you
guys,
won't
forgive
me.
I think we got a copyright strike on the Let's Play channel because it's not showing up. We're streaming on our other channels simultaneously to see if it works, but so far you've missed Fire Emblem announcement and Mario Party, and this is Fortnite. Yep.
Should I share this on social media or will it get copyrighted?
No, no. But I told you guys, Fortnite.
No problem observing that. And sorry, Blackwing, you missed a lot because they, as soon as we went live, as soon as they started showing the Nintendo games, like before it started showing it, it's almost like someone was waiting to hit the button.
I can't wait to drop off the battle bus and meet some of you on the battlefield in Fortnite. And on Nintendo Switch, you can have the complete Battle Royale experience, whether playing together online with friends in the same room or around the world. Available at 10 a.m. Pacific time today. Nintendo Switch, a home console where you can access a full range of games content, including a wealth of groundbreaking games from our independent development community. Your support for indie games on Nintendo Switch has been inspiring. And to all of you, as well as all of the developers behind these rich and varied experiences, from all of us here at Nintendo, thank you. Let's pull back the curtain on a few more, including two we're showing for the first time here today. Aspiring chefs, ready your cleavers, pots, and cutting boards.
The leaks are true. Overcooked 2.
A sequel that's brimming with more recipes.
Fortnite and Overcooked.
Kitchens,
Dragon Ball FighterZ should be announced today too.
Prepare for the ultimate cook-off with new features like.
Sorry guys, I'm upset. I got a copyright strike.
Kitchens that can change on the fly.
We can't stream on K-Wing's Let's Plays.
Opportunity to bake, barbecue, or broil with another player in wireless, local, and online play. Save the world from clumsy cooking when Team 17's frantic food juggler arrives on August 7th. Hop on a snail. Hoard berries or wipe out the enemy's queen to claim victory in Killer Queen Black. Redesigned from the ground up.
The entire leaks are true.
Bumble Bear Games acclaimed arcade extravaganza that became a multiplayer phenomenon is coming to Nintendo Switch. And for the first time on console, two teams of up to four each can
score. So all the leaks are true.
Exciting battles. Play it first on Nintendo Switch.
That's kind of upsetting though.
And finally, venture through the mysterious subterranean landscapes.
There's nothing we can do, guys. As soon as we started streaming, we got a copyright strike.
Hollow Knight.
Yeah. We lost the ability to live stream on the Let's Play channel for who knows how long.
And we do have a contract with
hand-drawn characters and sublime scenery abound in this sweeping platformer that offers endless hours of intricate exploration. We revealed earlier this year that Hollow Knight was coming to Nintendo Switch. And I'm pleased to announce that the game, packed with all the previous downloadable content, is available on the Nintendo eShop starting today.
I know you're not going to have a good day.
These are just a few of the terrific indie games you can play in the months ahead. After this presentation, stay tuned for Nintendo Treehouse Live, streaming right from the E3 show floor, where our Nintendo game experts will give you a closer look at some of these games and more. And I personally cannot wait to watch as intrepid challengers test their mettle in our Splatoon.
So there's
going to
be a Splatoon World Championship
and Super Smash Brothers.
Is that on data? Because that could be affecting our internet.
The action starts immediately following Nintendo Treehouse. Before we move on, I have an important update on a game I know fans have been looking forward to. Octopath Traveler from Square Enix is coming exclusively for Nintendo Switch on July 13th. And you can download a brand new demo for the game from the Nintendo eShop on June 14th. Now, let's take another action-packed look at some more experiences coming soon to Nintendo Switch.
Minasan.
Hi, everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi of Nintendo. I hope you enjoyed what you've seen. Recently, it's been nice to see people pull their Nintendo Switch systems from their bags to play, even when they have only a little bit of free time. Every time I see that, I can't help but smile. At Nintendo, we approach development with the goal of delivering new and unique games to surprise people all over the world, and we're thankful for the many publishing partners also making games for Nintendo Switch. Today, we share just a small portion of what we're currently working on. We hope you will look forward to what's coming next on Nintendo Switch. Now, it's time to share information on a certain title. I'll turn it over to someone I think you know.
Hi, I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited. Today, I'd like to introduce you to the new Super Smash Bros. Game for the Nintendo Switch. As you may know, Super Smash Bros. Is an action game about smashing beloved game characters off the screen. Many fighters have appeared in this series. I'm sure you are all eager to find out who will be joining the roster this time. So we made a video to showcase some fighters appearing in the game. The number next to each fighter signifies the order in which they joined the Super Smash Bros. Series. Please take a look.
What? Snake is back? How are all these... So pretty much every character is back. Holy cow. So what are the new characters then? Mega Man 2? What is this? Smash Brothers Ultimate. Okay. That's a lot of characters. How?
That's right. Every fighter in Super Smash Bros. History is joining the battle. Indeed, absolutely every Super Smash Bros. Fighter ever is in this game, whether they were originally DLC or only appeared once in the past. We believe that's what players want, so we made the impossible possible. Any way you slice it, this one has the most Smash for your buck. Simply put, this is the biggest crossover in gaming history. Once again, worlds will collide. Even so, your starting roster may be as small as the original Nintendo 64 game. We've streamlined the conditions for unlocking fighters, and we want to make the process interesting so it feels like you're constantly recruiting popular characters to your side.
Whoa.
8-player battles are also making a return. See what happens when you pit many different fighters against one another. Now let's take a closer look at certain fighters by highlighting how they've changed since their last appearance. Mario's still easy to use, but we did add a little something or someone from his latest adventure. He can also wear his wedding and builder outfits. Link dons his champion's tunic from The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild. His bombs are now remotely detonated, and his final smash unleashes ancient arrows. He can also wear Link's familiar tunic of the wild. Although it's been a while, the two-in-one fighter, the Ice Climbers, are back. Work together with Nana. Once she's gone, you're in serious trouble. Ike's outfit from Fire Emblem Path of Radiance returns, along with his look from Fire Emblem Radiant Dawn. Now you can use both versions for the first time. The two different versions are even voiced a little differently.
Prepare yourself. Prepare yourself.
We now have the female version of Pikachu, complete with a heart-shaped tail. Did you notice Pikachu Libre is a girl? Fox's design is now based on Star Fox Zero, and his Final Smash has received an overhaul. This time, Final Smashes are straight to the point, so you can get right back to fighting. Falco's Final Smash features an unorthodox ship formation that's more unruly than Fox's. Either way, the Landmaster has been retired. In one-on-one fights, Ryu will always face his opponents, just like in his original game appearances. It's a small touch that reduces accidental command inputs. Charge moves, like Samus's charge shot, can now power up in midair. You can cancel with jump or dodge, but you'll be open to attack.
Guys, I don't want to interrupt Sakurai because this is amazing.
Mark's
I'm just
blade is faster.
Even what happened with the Let's Play channel level. Today,
this is true for Roy and
this is incredible.
In addition, Marth is now fully voiced in English.
Keep your eyes open.
Backed by popular demand, veteran fighter Snake is sneaking back into the fray. It's been 10 years since his last appearance in the series, so we can finally make some new dream matches come true. Of course, Shadow Moses Island is back too. King DDD's final smash is basically a cage fight where he unleashes missiles and a jet hammer. Pichu is also returning from Super Smash Bros. Melee. Its electric shock still damages itself too, so be careful. In The Legend of Zelda: Breath of the Wild, Zelda is more into research than fighting, so her design is from The Legend of Zelda: A Link Between Worlds. Zelda is much more elegant and regal than our other fighters, but we made sure you wouldn't underestimate her energetic attacks. Her final smash is a ceiling move called Triforce of Wisdom. Sonic's final smash, Super Sonic, is more souped up than ever. Either you're too slow, or he's lightning fast. Pac-Man also got a speed boost this time around. Looping around the stage sounds just like Pac-Man, don't you think? Pokemon Trainer is back with Squirtle, Ivysaur, and Charizard. You can change Pokemon during battle, and this time there's no penalty for sticking with one, so feel free to pick your main. Also, you can play as a female trainer for the first time. Some fighters, like Captain Falcon, trigger a dramatic slow-mo effect on strong attacks in one-on-one fights. And of course, his hazardous Big Blue stage is making a return. Just like before, you can play as Cloud in his Final Fantasy VII costume or his Final Fantasy VII Advent Children costume. Now you can see his limit gauge near his damage percentage at all times. Special displays are available for certain other fighters too. For example, you can see how much longer Robin can use Levensword and Tomes. For Villager, we made it easier to see what you've pocketed. Between the male and female versions, there are 8 different Villagers. Bowser's final smash, Giga Bowser, is even bigger and better. He's now as big as Bowser from the Yoshi's Island game. All of Mr. Game & Watch's moves are back, and he looks even more like he did in his original games. His transformations are more full of character than ever. Young Link from Super Smash Bros. Melee is making a comeback that makes 3 Links for the first time. Lon Lon Milk, anyone? After 10 long years, Wolf makes his return. His design is based on Star Fox Zero, and each of his moves have received a significant upgrade. Kirby is his usual puffy self, but we've added a little something to his stone ability. He has a copy ability for every fighter, so the more fighters we have, the more challenging he becomes to develop. Shulk used to require repeated button presses to toggle Monado arts, but now you can choose a specific one with a button press and a quick directional tilt. Sure is handy to change arts on the fly. We also added Fiora to his final smash. Ganondorf rises again, returning to his popular design from The Legend of Zelda, Ocarina of Time. And for his final smash, he becomes Demon King Ganon. Mii Fighter's proportions have been tweaked a bit. There are 3 types: Brawler, Sword Fighter, and Gunner. The moveset for each type has also been enhanced, and you can now choose from 12 voice options. We're hoping to get this fighter ready for online play. Previously, Pit's final smash was 3 sacred treasures. This time, he'll be riding in style on the Lightning Chariot. In the last game, Zero Suit Samus's final smash called in her gunship. This time, she uses her power suit to fire a devastating laser. When Olimar gets damaged, you'll see a crack in his helmet. But don't worry. It'll get fixed up right away. Bayonetta's costumes from her first 2 games are both available. Listen closely and you'll hear differences in the sound effects. It seems we have a guest. Rodan appears as an assist trophy. Wario's final smash, Wario Man, has changed quite a bit. After transforming, he no longer uses individual attacks to get the job done. Donkey Kong's final smash is all rapid-fire punches like Donkey Kong Jungle Beat. You'll notice that he and other fighters have expressive new facial animations. Little Mac's final smash is now a rush of blows from Giga Mac. In fact, all final smash moves in the game get right to the punch. Ness's new final smash calls on Paula and Pooh. Of course, Jeff still shows up as an assist trophy. Likewise, Lucas's final smash features Kumatora and Bony. At first glance, Wii Fit Trainer seems the same, but her face has a new look. I wavered a bit on whether to change it, but it was a request from the Wii Fit developers. We've included all the hazards from both versions of Mega Man Stage from Super Smash Bros. For Wii U and Nintendo 3DS. And for his final smash, say hello to Proto Man and Bass. Palutena's special attacks have been streamlined this time around, and her down special is now both a counter and a deflector. Rob has a new gauge on his chassis showing how much fuel he has left for hovering. Notice the Epsilon symbols next to Lucina and Dark Pit's numbers? Each of these fighters are based on another fighter in the game. We're treating these fighters a little differently and have decided to call them Echo Fighters. Allow me to introduce a brand new Echo Fighter. Daisy joins the roster as Peach's Echo Fighter. She fights in a similar manner as Peach, but they have different characteristics, which we hope you'll enjoy. Have fun playing as your favorite princesses. All in all, if you add up the changes we're making, there could be tens of thousands. I hope you're looking forward to some serious matchups. And here's a new fighter. Inkling is a completely new addition to the roster. If you ink opponents, they'll take more damage from attacks. Different weapons are available as smash attacks or special attacks. The splatter shot, splat bomb, splat roller, and the final smash, killer whale. You can actually run out of ink, so it's important to refill by pressing the B button while shielding. Inkling Boy also debuts alongside Inkling Girl. Inklings are very fashionable. All 8 have their own outfits. And each has their own ink color, so matches get really bright. By the way, we added in the Squid Sisters as an assist trophy. During their live concert, the camera zooms in for a close-up. That means it's easier to get knocked off the screen. While we're on the topic of assist trophies, let me share some additional information. As you may know, assist trophies lend helpful support in battles. You can KO assist trophies by inflicting damage, and now you get points for it too. However, some assist trophies will remain unbeatable. Maybe an unexpected guest will photobomb your battle. Yep, it's him. There's a wide variety. More than 50 of them appear in the game. Of course, we're also adding even more Pokemon and items. We can't wait to show you. There are a variety of stages available in this game as well, including a massive list of returning stages. If you get a group together to play, it'll be a challenge to hit them all. The graphics have been improved as well. Let's get a look at some stages from various games. All stages now have both Battlefield and Omega forms too. These versions hover above an abyss. Their sizes and terrain are all the same, so savor the simplicity with music and background from your favorite series. Let's take a sneak peek at the new and returning techniques you can pull off during battles. The directional air dodge enhances mobility. It can come in handy when recovering from a fall. However, if you dodge too much, even on the ground, you'll be wide open to attack and your duration of intangibility gets shorter. You can execute short hop attacks by pressing the A button and jump at any time. Also, you can smash attack by pressing the A and B buttons just like the previous game. A perfect shield occurs when you release the shield button. Until now, you were able to pull it off without any major risks, but going forward, you'll need to time it carefully. For one-on-one battles, the damage dealt will now be greater than in battles with higher numbers of players. This should help ensure that the action is well-paced. In a timed battle, the fighter in the lead will sometimes flash with light. Better do something, or no victory pose for you. We've got something special for your playing pleasure in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Nintendo GameCube controllers can be used in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. For many of you, it just isn't the same without them. Not to mention, all Super Smash Bros. Series amiibo figures are compatible this time as well. In fact, all fighters' current amiibo figures will be supported, even if they're from a different series. Tap a compatible amiibo figure to add in a figure player, or FP, and level up. Your FP data from previous titles can be transferred. We hope you're as excited as we are. Our staff will continue working hard until the game releases. We really appreciate your support. We've made including every single fighter ever our number one goal, so I'm kind of hoping you aren't expecting too many new challengers. However, we do have one more announcement. Please, take a look.
Hey guys, a lot of problems with the Let's Play channel stream. I'm not in the best mood, but the Smash Brothers thing is really awesome. And they're showing a new character reveal, which I'm gonna go with Ridley. Although, I don't see how they're gonna do it. Put Ridley in this. How? Whatever. All right, that is cool. No release date for this yet. Any release date? Nintendo wins 2018.
It's for Christmas.
That's when Melee released.
Awesome.
Wait, that was it?
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Nintendo Treehouse Live from the Los Angeles Convention Center
and
E3. Minasan, ohayou gozaimasu. Los Angeles no E3 kaijou no Nintendo Treehouse Live no haishin
he
yo koso. I'd like to say thank you to everyone around the world for tuning in to our Nintendo Direct, as well as our fans in Japan. Zensekai no minasan ga Nintendo Direct wo mite.
I don't know what's going on, guys and gals. The Let's Play channel got hit. It can't live stream anymore. Right within 2 minutes of the Nintendo Direct, the thing was killed. The channel is still working as far as I know, but it can't live stream. There's no internal errors that we can see. There's no email that says, you know, copyright strike or anything like that. It won't stream.
Yeah, so, it felt like somebody was waiting until when our stream went... when the Nintendo footage came up, and then they clicked it, which is frustrating. You would think it would be nicer of them to have, like clicked it at the beginning so we knew we couldn't stream it, and then we could have made other plans or informed our fans, but I don't understand how they work.
So, I mean, I don't know what's going to happen to the other videos, but I'll let you guys watch the live stream. I don't even know if I'm going to watch it, to be honest. I'm just really mad.
Yeah, that was very cool, Blackwing. And yeah, I mean, like, everyone was saying, like, Josh and everybody, you guys were saying, and Matthew, you guys were saying that this is the best E3 showcase, and I agree. I think it was the best, don't you think? Mm-hmm. And Luke was really excited about everything. In fact, he was just saying to me that, you know, like, he felt so disappointed because he wanted to show the best one, and we were doing it on the Let's Play channel, and it didn't, like... It suddenly just cut out right when they were showing all the good stuff. And we didn't even get the stream finally up on Luke's channel until the very end. So, until just now, basically. But everything looked really great. The mech suit thing. I do wish... I mean, people were saying they wish there was another character in Smash. Like, I think Ed and other people were saying that.
There's going to be a couple questions. But why don't we let them do their thing? And, yeah. So, if you guys want to watch this, we'll have it going for a while or whatever. But...
Alright,
so the biggest appeal of this game is really that everyone, every single fighter is back here, and you know, may continue the Smash series in the future, but I don't know if we'll ever be able to pull this off, so I really hope that you'll enjoy this iteration of the game.
I certainly plan to.
Oh yeah. まあ、僕は enjoy する
私も楽しみです。Me too.
Well, so we, Mr. Sakurai really delineated a lot of the specific moves for returning fighters in the video, but we only got a taste of Ridley at the very end. So what I was hoping we could do is maybe play through a little bit with Ridley live on stage here so we can talk a little bit more about his moves and see what he looks like in action.
まあ、桜井さんは今までの、ファイターたちの技とかをいろいろ説明していただきましたけれども、はい、リドリーはほんの少しだけ見られましたので、今朝は実演プレイでリドリーの技も紹介していただけないでしょうか。
そうですね。じゃあ直接触ってやりますね。 All right, yeah, let's go ahead and give you guys a tour.
Where would you like to fight?
どこで戦いましょうか?
とりあえず説明だけなんで、その終点で。
So I'm just going to do an explanation, so let's just go to Final Destination.
All right.
And this Final Destination is actually a special version of Final Destination that is going to be slightly different from the version that's in the full game, correct?
そうです。今の終点が本編とちょっと違って E3 会場専用のバージョンですね。
そうなってます。
That's correct.
And that was a bit of a change right there that we picked the stage before the characters.
で、今ご覧の通り、ちょっと違うところなんですけれども、一番最初に選ぶのがファイターじゃなくてステージですね。
それについては後で説明しましょうか。
はい。
とりあえずリドリーについて説明します。
And let me get into Ridley now.
リドリーは、ご存知の通り、いや、知らない方もおられるかもしれませんが、メトロイドシリーズの、サムスの宿敵ですね。
As you may or may not know, Ridley is from the Metroid series and is the arch nemesis of Samus.
全体的に、他のファイターと比べてとても実は身長が高いんですね。4メートルぐらいあります。
And comparatively, he's actually very, very tall. He's about 4 meters tall.
その体育から、とてもまとめるのが難しかったのですが、特に海外からの要望がすごく高かったために、リドリーを実践させることにしました。
And because of that, it was very hard to actually get him into the game in a working condition, but there was a lot of outcry from fans, especially overseas, so we decided to put him in.
キャラクター性は、スマブラの中では全体的に残虐な方です。
In terms of his characteristic, in terms of Smash Brothers, he's very much on the cruel side.
スマブラ X で、アドベンチャーモードというのがありまして、サムスを壁にこすりつけたりしていましたが、
And in Brawl, he made an appearance as a boss, and he would do moves like grabbing Samus and just dragging her across the wall.
今回は地面にこすりつけたりします。
And now he drags other fighters along the floor.
おっといけない。
Oops.
何やってんでしょうね。
I win!
僕が勝った。
Sorry about that.
投げの途中でジャンプをしたりとか、特殊な挙動を取ることもできます。
You can do jumps while he's grabbing onto opponents and do all other kinds of technical moves.
それとニュートラル必殺技は炎の弾を吐くんですけれども。
And his neutral special is a fireball, as you can see.
こう貯めると複数の弾を吐くことができます。
And charging it up, you can throw multiple fireballs.
実は原作と同じで、貯めてる時の口の中が弱点なんですね。
And just like the original game, his weak point is actually when he's charging up the fireball in his mouth.
頑張って。今26のダメージになってますけど、かなり食らいました。
So just from that one hit, he took about 26% of damage right now, but you take big damage.
あと、さっき間違えて使ってしまった必殺技上、こういう吹き技になってるんですが。
And his up special is what you just saw right here.
方向を4方向に変えることができます。
And you can go in any four directions you'd like.
斜め前と斜め下では、少し角度が違うんですね。
And you can actually set it to diagonally down or forward or diagonally down backward, and the angle is a little bit different for each.
それと、下必殺技、こういうのがあるんですけれども、これがちょっと特殊な技でして。
And he also has a down special that you just saw, and this has a very unique attribute.
マリオの体力ゲージに注目してください。
Please take a close look at Mario's damage percentage.
という。これ、この技にはスイートスポットがあって、そこに直撃すると、大ダメージを与えることができます。そうじゃないところではもうすごいカス当たりをするんですね。
So this move actually has a sweet spot, and when you hit it right at the sweet spot, it takes huge, massive damage. But if you don't and just attack normally, it's very minimal damage.
これはやっぱり4人対戦の時の方が当たりやすいと思います。
And I think, relatively speaking, I think it's easier to hit that sweet spot when you're doing a four-player match.
ということで、リドリーの説明は以上です。
All right, and I think that wraps up Ridley's moveset.
Well, I'd like to stop just getting beaten up here for a second, so I was kind of hoping that next maybe we could actually play a match and see what it looks like in action. How do you guys feel about that?
まあ、デコボコにされることはちょっとお読みしたいと思ってますけれどもせっかくですので、ネッツさんとエリックさんが2人で対戦してもらいましょうか。
はい。
Sounds good. I don't think you're going to stop getting beaten up, but you know, we'll see what happens.
デコボコにならないかどうかわからないんですけれども。
じゃあとりあえずサムスとリドリーですね。少し解説を交えながらお話をしたいと思います。
All right. Got Samus and Ridley, and I'll do some commentating while we're battling.
まず先ほど少し触れていた、ステージセレクトの方が先だったという話について。
So first I'd like to start off with what Nate mentioned earlier about having a stage select before you select the fighters.
ステージには少なくともファイターに対する相性というのがあります。極端な話だと、リトルマックだと平地が有利なんですね。
You know, every fighter and every stage has advantage and disadvantage in combination. So if you look at kind of the extreme, Little Mac is very useful on a flat surface.
そこで、ステージを先に選ぶことにしました。特に敗者が選ぶ、負けた側が選ぶようにすると、さらに公平度が増すと思います。
And so to add a little bit of strategy, we decided to be able to select the stage beforehand. And that way, in a series of matches, the loser gets to pick the stage.
Well,今、スコア表示が出たのがお分かりでしょうか。
And I think you might have seen the score display there.
1対1の場合、ああいうスコア表示を行うことにしました。ゼロになったら負けです。
And then, for one-on-one battles, we decided to put a score, display the score like that. And obviously, you lose when you reach zero.
Don't do this.
Oops, didn't make it.
Good triumphs.
復帰ができなかったですね。
なんかネイトさんって容赦ないですよね。
Nate has no mercy, does he?
That's right.
Never.
新キャラに対してね。
Especially for, against a new fighter.
おっと。
おー、
来た。
There we go.
Oh, come on, man. It's just, that should be illegal.
それはもう本当にいいんですかって。
まあまだ開発中のバージョンですし、ダメージ値とか当たりやすさについてはこれからも調整の余地があるかもしれません。
And of course, this game is still in development, so the damage ratio, where the sweet spot is, things like that may change in the future.
それと、ムービー中でもお話をしていました、ワンオンワンダメージというのが適用されているので、普通に4人対戦でやるときよりもダメージ値が高くなってます。
And as I mentioned in the video earlier, there is this one-on-one damage where you take on more damage, and that's been implemented here.
そうこうしてる間に今同点になってますね。
And as we speak, we're at we're at a tie right now.
今はまた新しいアイテムですね。This is a new item we see on screen here.
その名もブラックボールというんですけれども。
And this new item is called Black Hole.
その中に中心に相手を吸い込むタイプのものです。
Basically, what happens is it attracts all the fighters into the center of that black hole.
あとお話しした通り、アシストフィギュアを撃墜することができますが、これはタイム制とかじゃないと得点が関係ないので、今回はそんなにメリットないかも。起きましたね。
And I was talking about assist trophies, and it's usually only gets points in time matches, but as we're speaking, we got a finals match.
And you can see Samus's ship crashing in the background.
そうです。
後ろにサムスの宇宙船が撃墜してるっていうのが見えますよね。
No. あの落ち方もいろいろ監修しましたよ。
Enjoy that. Yep. Enjoy that.
Did a lot of review for that animation.
And it looks like we've added some new technology to the game as well.
All right.
新しいポケモンも今出ましたよね。
あれは前作から出ています。Oh. ダークライですね。
Yeah, that's Darkrai from the previous title.
Get out.
Galaga はまだダメージが低いので簡単に助かります。
So yeah, the damage ratio was low, and that's why we were able to get out of Lost Galaga.
お、新しいボンバーです。
And this is a new item.
Let's just stick this up in the air real quick. Oh, come over here. Come over here.
Ah.
That was bad.
今のワークスターにも新しい仕様がつきまして、上を押してると時間を調整できるようになりました。早く落ちたり遅く落ちたりすることができます。
And we actually added a new spec to the warp star. So holding up, you can actually delay when the warp star falls.
Sorry.
And you can adjust when either make it quickly or slower.
I'm burning now.
今サムスがカレーを出ましたけれども、前から疑問だったんですけど、海外の人ってカレーをわかるんですか？
I was always curious, you know, Samus ate the curry, but I was wondering, do overseas people get that, you know, it's burning and spicy?
Oh yeah, oh yes.
Americans love curry. Americans が辛口のカレーが大好きです。
知りませんでした。
Oh, I didn't know that. Good to know.
I just like to point out that I won while we were talking.
今喋ってる間にネイトさんが優勝しましたねって。
そうですね。おめでとうございます。
Congratulations,
Samus. What did Ridley ever do to you? Why you gotta be like that?
サムスなんでそういうことするんですか。リトリーがそれだけ悪いことしたんですか。
Well, besides tell your parents, of course. So, Mr. Sakurai, would you like to play one?
じゃあ4人で戦いましょうか。
やりますか。
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
Let's do a four-player match. What do you guys say?
Sounds good. こちら4人対戦しましょう。
はい。
So that's gonna
どちらで？
じゃあサクルダイさんは
こっちじゃなくて、これだと。
I think over on this one.
Ah.
Hmm.
あれこっち。
こっちですね。So we're on,
コントローラーをください。
はい、どうぞ。
はい、どうも。
All right. Now we got controllers.
No.
We're gonna grab. We grab.
We'll figure it out.
お、2P。
It looks like I'm second player. Link でいこうかな。Maybe I'll go with Link?
I'm gonna go with Ganondorf.
And perhaps I will stick with Mario since we just saw Nate get beat up as Mario.
Oh.
Nate was Mario to say. ボロボロになってしまったので、僕はちょっとマリオを
そうなんですか。なんかマリオが好きだっつってましたよね。
そうですね。
He did say you like Mario.
So we are on Great Plateau Tower here, from Breath of the Wild.
今のあの Breath of the Wild の始まりの塔ですね。
はい。リンクは体力が、蓄積ダメージがないときには、剣ビームが、ソードビームが出るんですね。
Nice. So Link, when he has no damage, he can actually shoot a blade beam out.
実は、Nintendog は犬種が変わってます。
And I don't know if you noticed, but Nintendogs, the type of dog has changed.
実はスマブラ X の時から出てるんですけど、毎回犬種を変えています。
And I don't know if you noticed, but the Nintendogs have been coming out since Brawl, but every time it's been a different type of dog.
前は、日本語で言うとフレンチブルだったんですけれども、今回は日本語で言うトイプードルになってます。
So it used to be a French Bulldog in the last iteration, but this time it's a toy poodle.
行くよ。
Here we go.
Nope. Oh, not me, not me, that's you. Come on. I guess I am getting
Carp. Oh, Curry.
ちょっとね、さっきから狙われてません?
Are you guys picking on me?
Come on, picking on no one, I'm just dying.
Maybe.
Mazui.
Oh no.
Mazui ne.
That was not good.
I love seeing that tower collapse and then a new platform appears.
そうですね、タワーが壊れてしまって、新しいプラットフォームが現れるっていうのがすごいですね。
I cannot.
Oops.
でも若い。
We're good.
受け身も取ったし。あっちちゃう。
Something I don't know if people are noticing. Oh, come on, Bill. I'm trying to talk here. Ganondorf now has sword attacks for all of his smash moves. And they hit really hard.
ビデオでも見られましたけれども、ガナンドルフが、今回は、
そうです、時のおかげになってます。
そうですね、ソードの攻撃もできるようになりました。
That's right. And he also, as I mentioned earlier, looks like, is look from, Ocarina of Time.And that was unfortunate.
Ah, やっちゃった.
Oops.
Oh, 来てる熊.
Oh, beware.
エロイ刺激は強いですよ, かなり.
His attack is very strong.
今ガロンドルフが光ったような気がしますが。
Did Ganondorf just have a little sparkle? Is that,
no.
is that my imagination?
I think it must have been because I've been getting destroyed.
Yeah, 結構負けてると思いますので。違うと思います。
Oh, I guess so.
届かなかった。あれ、意外と試合時間が長いんだな。あ、そっか。
We got a good match going here.
Oh, why did I drive right into that?
おっと。危ない。ああ、やっちゃった。
あ。
お、ラスにつけました。
Yes.
Oh, that was. Ah, 今のが良くなかったですね。
しかしこれ賑やかなゲームですね。
Oh, what a rowdy game this is.
You died. It doesn't count.
もうやってしまいましたけれども、同時に落とされてしまったので。
What?
マオガロン。ああ、二人今。
Thinking.
でも一点もらいました。
I did get one point though.
あれ、いけない。見失っちゃった、今。
Oh. I lost track of my character.
Oh, oh man, how did that miss?
That was
serious.
これはガノンドルフじゃないですか。
なぜそんなことするんですか。
そういうゲームだからしょうがないですよね。
No, you don't, Bill.
Ah! Don't do it!
Don't die down there!
Uh-huh.
Self-destruct's not gonna help things.
Oh, yeah,
oh,
look at that.
That's a ringer. That is a ringer.
それはちょっとアンフェアじゃないですか。
アンフェアですね。ずるいですよね。
ずるいですね。
I guess it is unfair.
本当すみません。
Sorry about that.
悪いことした？
Did I do something bad?
Wow, that was fun.
Yeah, that was.
Yeah. I almost want to play again.
Yes.
楽しかったですね。
うん、面白いですね。
もう一回やってみたいですね。
I need a little break first.
やりますか？
ちょっと手が汗だらけってネイトさんが言ってました。
I need to cool down.
なんか放送であることを忘れて遊んじゃいますね。
You know, it's the type of game where you kind of forget that you're on live, so you just want to play and have fun.
Yeah. So we've obviously talked about Ridley. We also in the direct we talked about how this game is going to use all of the previous amiibo.まあ、今朝はリドリーの紹介もできましたし、ダイレクトの中には、今回のスマブラは過去のアミーボは全部使えるようになるっていう話はありましたよね。
そうですね。
So, that does leave us with the question of what would happen in the case of if you wanted a Ridley amiibo. ってことは、リドリーのアミーボは結局どうなるかっていうのが思いますよね。
まあ、思うでしょうね。
Yeah, so, I would think so.
I think maybe we should take this opportunity.To show an incredibly detailed Ridley amiibo that will be launching alongside the game. せっかくですので、本当にね、ディテールがすごい、リドリーのアミーボソフトと同発なんですけれども、そして、スマブラシリーズの、新しいインクリングのアミーボもあります。And we also have a new Inkling amiibo for the Smash Brothers series.
私リドリーの立体物って初めて見ましたね。
I think this is the first time I've seen like a 3D realization of Ridley.
もちろん作ってる最中からこれは見てるんですけれども。
I mean, obviously I've seen it during production and development, but.
あとちょっとだけくだらない話をしていいですか？
And can I share something a little, maybe a little nerdy?
Yes, sure, please.
実はインクリングのアミーボって初めてではないじゃないですか。そこで前のインクリングのアミーボとどこが違うっていうところを一つ挙げると、実は後ろのタンクのメーターの三角の位置が違うんですね。
So, there is already an Inkling amiibo, and now that we have a Smash Inkling amiibo, and I wanted to kind of point out one difference between those two, and it's that the little triangle ticker on the ink tank behind the Inkling, the location of that triangle ticker is different.
それは、スプラッシュボムを1回投げた時に減るインクの量を表しています。これは、スマブラでは必殺技になっているので結構たくさんスプラッシュボムを打てるんですね。だから仕様が変わってそうなっています。
And that denotes how much ink you use up when you use the splat bomb. But the amount of ink you use in Splatoon and Smash is different. It's in Smash it's a special move, so you can use a lot more splat bombs. So the spec is a little different.
Details, man.
Details.
Yeah. Details.
And although we don't have a figure to show today, we did also introduce Daisy as an Echo Fighter in the game. And we can confirm that there will also be a Daisy amiibo in the Smash Brothers series releasing as well.でまあ、今日は実物は見せられないんですけれどもビデオの中には、デイジーがピーチ姫のダッシュファイターとして紹介されたんですけれどもスマブラシリーズのアミーボのデイジーも一応用意します。
はい、そうですね。
じゃあせっかくですのでまた遊んでみましょうか。
もう一戦
もう一戦
で、ね、
じゃあやりましょう。
Should we have one more battle?
Quick rematch. Let's do it. I think we're over there.
おっこれ届かない。
ありがとう。
Thank you, thank you.
Nope, that one's a little bit shorter.
Thank you, Bill.
There we go.
じゃあ、インクリングの話も出たし、インクリング用のステージで行きますか。
Well, we did talk about Inkling, so shall we go to the Inkling stage?
そうですね。Let's do that.
Why not?
うん。
誰かインクリング混ぜた方がいいでしょうね。
Maybe someone can be the Inkling, maybe.
Oh.
I'm going Pokemon. I'll go Inkling.
Okay.
じゃあ、クッパで行ってみようかな。
Maybe I'll go
Bowser. あ、そうだ。パイクなんですけど、大人と子供じゃないや。
超
円と暁版があります。
Two different versions. Path of Radiance and Radiant Dawn.
せっかくだからアイクで行ってみよう。
And I will go with Zelda.
I love the Zelda redesign. I think her artwork is excellent.
ああ、そうですね。ゼルダのキャラモデルも変わりましたね。デザインが素晴らしいです。
良くなったでしょう。
Yeah, it looks good, right?
今まではゼルダシリーズって同じシリーズからの選抜だったんですね。今回はバラに変えられるようになったので、それぞれ好きなところを選んでみました。
So in the past, we've made it so all the Zelda-related characters are all from the same series. But this time, we've spread it out. So I picked what I really liked.
ここは坂があるので、アイテムをうまく活用できないんですね。
So this stage has a lot of hills, so it's actually kind of difficult to use items properly.
ところで、そのスマッシュボールは危ないですよ。
I was gonna say that smash ball is.
Could you speed up on the translation, Raymond, when he has like salient info like that?
通訳をもうちょっと早くお願いします。
そうですね。
I'll work on it.
スマッシュボールと偽物がスマッシュボームっていうんですけれども、これは十字の形などで確認をすることができます。
So there's an actual smash ball and then there's a fake smash ball in there, and you can discern which one is fake by the markation on the ball.
あれは本物です。
That is a real one.
Yes.
来たよ。
Here we go.
いいです。いい位置。
That's nice positioning.
That's not gonna be good.
Not pretty good to me.
まあやられて本物かなと。
That did not feel good.
That was a worthy.
Lunala です。
And that was Lunala just now.
おっと。なお、インクリングにペイントされたキャラクターは蓄積ダメージのたまる量が、つまりダメージ量が大きくなるので要注意ですね。
And as I mentioned, when characters are painted by the Inkling's ink, they actually end up taking more damage, so you gotta beware.
Stop doing that.
You went right through that.
I don't care. Paint me all you want.
おっといけない。
Oops.
ああやっちゃった。
Didn't make it.
Oh, I wanted that.
Come on. Oh, I just gotta live.
サドンかな？
サドン。
Oh snap! Three-way sudden death.
Oh.
Yes, I did not have a good match.
僕は全然サドンですが、こうやって画面が迫るようになってます。
And sudden death.
No, not again.
So,
hey,
come on. My screen keeps zooming in.
Mr. Sakurai.
And there we go.
Wow, is that two wins?
Yeah, it's two wins for Mr. Sakurai.
He's got skills. He's played before.
2勝ですね。
Injustice.
やっぱり腕前があります。
接待プレーありがとうございます。
Thank you for a wonderful game.
So humble.
Well, I think, before we go, if there's anything, last thoughts that Mr. Sakurai wants to leave the fans with, I really appreciate you spending time with us today. So any final thoughts for everybody watching?
じゃあ、終わる前に Sakurai さんからの最後の一言は何かありますでしょうか？
そうですね。今、キャラクターが出ていたと思うんですけれども、これは E3 バージョンを使っています。その E3 バージョンで、日本を含めいろいろなところでこれから試遊できることになると思います。まだ開発中ですし、バランス調整中ですが、ある程度のキャラクターは触れると思いますので、機会がありましたらぜひ触っていただければと思います。そして発売日をお待ちいただければと思います。
So the characters you just saw, it's part of the E3 version, and I think this version will may become playable and in certain time. And I hope that, and obviously we're in the middle of development and balancing is still being made, so it may be some changes, but I hope that if you have the opportunity to please check it out. We can't include all the characters, but I think you'll get a good feel for it. And I really hope you look forward to the release of the game.
That's great. Well, it's been really fun losing to you over and over again. But thank you so much for spending time with us today. It's been really fun.
もうずっと負けっぱなしでしたけれども本当に楽しかった時間どうもありがとうございました。どうもありがとうございました。
Thank you very much.
And thank you for tuning into Treehouse Live. We have more coming up. There will be more Smash Brothers with lots of detail on additional characters over the course of E3. But coming up next, after a short break, we're going to have the world's first hands-on play with Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee, along with a very special guest.
Treehouse Live はこの後続きますけれども、そしてスマブラの紹介もどんどんここ3日間紹介していきますけれども、次はポケモンレッツゴーピカチュウ、ポケモンレッツゴーイービーの世界初実演プレイを紹介したいと思っています。多少ブレーキがありますけれども、その後特別なゲストまた登壇しますので、引き続きよろしくお願いします。
Good morning, everyone, and welcome back to Nintendo Treehouse Live at the LA Convention Center and at E3. 皆さんおはようございます。ツリーハウスライブようこそ。またロサンゼルスの E3 の会場から配信しています。Today we are very, very fortunate. We have a very special guest, Mr. Masuda from Game Freak, and he has even brought Pikachu with him.
今朝は特別なゲストも登壇していただいて、Game Freak の Masuda さんとピカチュウも連れてきましたね。
ピカチュウ来ました。
And translating for him, we have David, along with Eevee.
で通訳はデイブドさんにお願いしてイービーも連れてきています。
I am Bill Trinan and this is Teresa. We're from Nintendo.
で我々は Nintendo の、ビルトリネンと、テレサさんです。よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
Before we begin playing Masuda-san, I wanted to hear from you, and I think everybody would like to hear from you. First, what were your goals in designing and developing Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee?
じゃあ実演プレイを始まる前に増田さんの方から、うん、今回のピカチュウレッツゴー、ポケモンレッツゴーピカチュウ、ポケモンレッツゴーイービーの開発にあたって一番達成したいこと、はい、目的っていうのが何なんでしょうか。
そうですね、一番初めやっぱり考えてたのは本当にこう世界中の多くの人に遊んでもらいたいなって思って、今までこう携帯型のゲーム機で開発をしてきましたけど、今回スイッチということで、やっぱりリビングでみんなでワイワイと楽しんでほしいなと思って、そういう意味でみんなが遊べるポケットモンスターを開発しようと思いました。
So as we always do with the Pokemon games, we really want everyone around the world to really enjoy these games. Up until now, we've developed them on handheld systems, but this time around, of course, it's on Nintendo Switch, which we envision people are going to be playing in their living room. So we had another take on Pokemon in general, of, you know, what would that look like, and what would a Pokemon for everyone be?
まあ、それ考えたときに自分たちやっぱり子供たちが今ポケモン GO とかで、まあ、プレイできてない人たちもいるので、ポケモン GO ユーザーも、まあ、本編を遊んだことなかったりするので、まあ、みんなで本当に楽しめると、まあ、GO ユーザーも子供たちも今までのファンのみんなも楽しめるポケットモンスター、それが今回のレッツゴーピカチュウレッツゴーイブになります。
I also had in mind a lot of the younger kids maybe don't have their own smartphones to play Pokemon Go. There's so many people out there playing Pokemon Go, but some of the younger kids maybe didn't get a chance to do that. So I had them in mind, as well as all of our existing fans, really wanting this to be truly a Pokemon for everyone.
Great. Well, why don't we take a look at the game and show the world Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu?
では早速ですけれども、
はい、
実演プレイに入って世界の皆さんにポケモン Let's Go Pikachu を紹介しましょうか。
そうですね。
This is Viridian Forest that we have just entered.
今は時輪の森ですよね。
そうです、ここは皆さん昔の時輪の森を覚えてますでしょうか。こんな3D で美しい時輪の森になりました。
This may be a familiar location for a lot of our fans that played the older games, but they've kind of come back to life in 3D here
Yes, it looks wonderful. You can see Pokemon out in the field. You can see the shafts of light.
でまあ、本当に素晴らしいですね。光とか、その草むらのポケモン見えたりしてますし、
そうですね、みんな出てきてますね、草むらから。
そうですね。
You see all the Pokemon popping up from the grass.
And I see here that we've entered now a wild Pokemon battle, and we've changed the mechanics for how we're capturing wild Pokemon. Can you tell us about that a bit?
で今は、野生のポケモンの捕まえる画面ですよね。
はい、
これは多少変わりましたよね。それをちょっと説明していただけますか。
そうですね。今までバトルで押して、野生ポケモンの HP を減らして、まあ、ボールを投げるっていう仕組みだったんですけど、今回はリビングで家族で、まあ、家庭でみんなで遊んでもらうということから、まあ、直感的にこうジョイコンを片手で持って投げると、まあ、ボールを投げて捕まえる遊びっていうのを中心にしています。
Up until now in the Pokemon games, the wild Pokemon you encounter, you go into a battle and then you kind of reduce their hit points, weaken them a bit, and then you're able to catch them. But with these games being on Nintendo Switch and of course in the living room, we figured people would be playing along with their friends and family. And we wanted to do a new take on this kind of Pokemon catching experience with these intuitive controls where you're just kind of flicking the Nintendo Switch controller and throwing out Pokeballs.
これ Pokemon Go で直感的にこうスマホでボールを投げてたんですけども、まあ、それがかなり、まあ、多くの方に遊びやすく受け入れられたっていうのもあって、今回、それをさらにこうスイッチのジョイコンで、ジョイコン振るっていう遊びに
体験型に進化させました。
And that's taking a hint from Pokemon Go, which I worked on and came up with the catching mechanic in that, which used the smartphone controls. People found that really intuitive, I think. They're widely accepted and kind of gained a lot of popularity. So I wanted to do a take on that using the Joy-Con to a similar style where it's much more interactive and kind of an experiential thing.
Yes, and in fact, you mentioned the Joy-Con, and Teresa is playing with a single Joy-Con. You're able to play the entire game with just one Joy-Con. で、今、Joy-Con の話は出ましたけれども、実は、Joy-Con 片手で遊べるようになってますよね。すべての操作ができるようになってます。そうなんです。
これ意外とあの快適で、あの皆さんあのポップコーンを食べながら片手でゲームが遊べるっていうですね、この気軽感がなんともいいと思います。
Yeah, I think having one Joy-Con, being able to play the entire game with it is a very comfortable and kind of a pleasurable experience. You can maybe be eating popcorn with your other hand, for example.
And I also see that when you capture wild Pokemon, you earn experience points, and those get shared among the entire Pokemon in your party.
で、今あの見たように野生のポケモンを捕まえると経験値がたまりますよね。はい、それが、パーティーのポケモンに割り当てますよね。
そうですね。これであの手持ちのポケモンたちがまあどんどんこう強くなっていくということに、しています。今回はあの捕獲、まあ、捕まえることで、まあ、より、楽しめると、よりポケモンたちが育つということをあのベースに作っています。
You're gaining experience points, of course, levels up the Pokemon in your party, gets them stronger. So that's how you kind of, you know, strengthen your Pokemon. It's the main mechanic of that. We really wanted to focus on that catching experience, so made sure that you can also strengthen your Pokemon just by catching Pokemon.
And I think you also can do different throwing motions to try to catch Pokemon as well.
で、ポケモンのあの捕まえる時の投げ方もいろいろ工夫してますよね。
そうですね。あの斜めに振ると斜めにボルト出たり。あの横からこう横にサイドスローするとあの横に飛んでったりと、そのまあ今あの最初の頃はあまりポケモン動いてないんですけど、後半になるとポケモンが動き出すんで、それに合わせていろんな投げ方でテクニックで、皆さんのテクニックをあのどんなテクニックでも、いろんなテクニックで遊んでほしいなと思ってます。
Yeah, you can do a variety of different throwing techniques, like if you can put a little bit of an angle on it to throw diagonally or throw to the side or even do an underhand lob type of thing. And right now in these early parts of the game, you'll see that the Pokemon aren't moving around very much, but later on they're going to be moving around, so you're going to need to try a lot of different techniques.
Oh, Pikachu. Oh.
It looks like a female Pikachu. 女性バージョンですね。
そうですね。あの、時はの森といえば、まあ、ピカチュウなんですけど。
I think Viridian Forest, you know, Pikachu is well known for this location.
So, Teresa, do you want to try a side throw or something like that?
Yeah, definitely. And because Pikachu is a little bit more of a challenge to catch, I'm going to switch to an Ultra Ball.
じゃあ、あの、サイドスローをちょっと試してみますけれども、はい、ピカチュウがより、捕まえにくいので、ウルトラボールの方に変えます。
ちょっと斜めに行きましたね。
はい、like a little bit of a diagonal throw there.
Yes.
Nice job.
Thank you.
やりました。Nice. よかった。
Now, I think we've been seeing as Teresa is walking around that her character has Pikachu on the shoulder, but there's also a Charmander following her around. Can you talk a little bit about the differences between the two partner Pokemon?
で、まあ、ご覧のように、テレサさんが歩き回っている間にピカチュウが肩に乗っていて、後ろに人影が追ってるんですけれども、はい、この2つのポケモンの違いについて説明していただけますか？
あの肩に、主人公の肩に乗っているのが、相棒のピカチュウです。レッツゴーピカチュウでは、ピカチュウが、相棒として肩に乗っていて、レッツゴーイーブイでは、頭の上に、主人公の頭の上に、イーブイが乗って、一緒に冒険を共にします。で、後ろにいるのはあの連れ歩きのポケモンでして、今回は、全ての、151のポケモンが連れ歩くことができます。で、場合によってあの大きなポケモンは乗ることができたりと、いろいろ楽しめます。
In these games, you have your partner Pokemon, which is, of course, Pikachu and Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee and Let's Go Eevee. Pikachu rides on your shoulder, Eevee rides on your head. And besides that, you can have any of the other Pokemon that you catch in the game follow behind you, in addition to your partner Pokemon. Some of them, you can even ride on them if they're big enough, so there's definitely a lot of variation to the Pokemon that will follow you.
And now I see we've entered into our first trainer battle, and what we see with the trainer battles is that this is a more traditional
battle screen type of an experience.
今あの初めてのトレーナーバトルなんですけれども、見てみると通常のバトルと同じような画面になってますね。
そうですね。まあ、あのポケモンの特徴といいますか、まあ、ポケモンらしさというのもありまして、そこは非常にあの大事にしてます。まあ、人と人と、トレーナー同士でバトルをするという楽しみは、まあ、とても大事ですし、あとはあの通信対戦と、まあ、同じような、形でやっぱりこう人と人が、それぞれのポケモンを持って、勝負をするというのは、まあ、そこの、あのポイントは押さえています。
That competitive battling aspect, you know, players between players or Pokemon trainers versus Pokemon trainers is really part of what makes Pokemon Pokemon, so we definitely preserve the battles as they were in previous games. You can also, of course, battle against the trainers in the game, but also do linked battles, so playing against other real players, battling each other with your Pokemon.
なので今回はあの捕獲の時はこうジョイコンを振って、捕まえるっていう遊びと、トレーナー同士で、こうバトルするっていう2つの遊び方をそれぞれ、分けて構築されています。
So in these games, you'll see that there's quite a difference between the catching gameplay, which you're using the Joy-Con to flick out and throw out Pokeballs, and then the battle gameplay, which is more traditional selecting commands to fight, issue moves and battle against the other trainer.
Yeah, and I think we see the Pokemon in the grass. We've even seen with some of the Pokemon that there are graphic indicators, some kind of aura around the Pokemon.
Oh,
is that correct?
Oh.
あの今まで、歩き回りながら、草むらのポケモンが見えたりしてますけれども、周りに何かあのグラフィックスとかオーラが見えるようになってますね。
そうですね。あの大きさに合わせてあの赤いオーラがあったりあの青いオーラがあって、これも、まあ、あの何匹も捕まえたくなる要素として設計してるんですけども、まあ、大きいポケモンがいたらぜひ捕まえてほしいなと思います。赤いマークが目印ですね。
We did this to really make it so you players would want to catch even a bunch of the same species of Pokemon, so there's a little bit of differentiators there, like a red aura to indicate bigger Pokemon of that species, or blue aura to indicate that they're much smaller than normal.
こうやってあの人影が、ね、一緒にくっついてくるだけでちょっと楽しいですよね。
Even just having Charmander follow you around like this is kind of fun as a Pokemon trainer.
That's right, and I notice here that Pikachu's wagging its tail.
で、ここ見てみるとピカチュウが尻尾を振ってますね。
はい、あの相棒がの特別な能力なんですけど、あの道具があると、尻尾を振ってお知らせしてくれます。
It's a special ability or power, you might say, of your partner Pokemon. It'll wag its tail when there's an item nearby, and letting you know that there's something to pick up.
So it looks like with the redesign of the Kanto region that as you've turned it into 3D, you've really taken that into account to kind of hide items throughout the world.
で、今回の関東地方が、まあ、3D で作ることになって、それを使っていろいろ工夫もしてますし、あのアイテムの隠しとかもしてますね。
そうですね。やっぱりこう、今まで 2D で本当にドット絵でモノクロでっていうのがまあ元々あって、でそれはこうして 3D になったことで、まあ、楽しさとか面白さっていうのを、まあ、魅力的に見せるようにより魅力的に見せるように構築しています。
That's right. I think the original games that we based these off of, you know, back there on the Game Boy, 2D, pixel art, monochrome, or not monochrome, but you know, black and white pretty much. And these times I think we've recreated them in 3D, so there's going to be a lot of fun things that players are going to be able to discover, and I think we've really made them just kind of look really more appealing than before.
Yeah, I really love the graphic look of the game because it does feel like it's gotten a lot closer to what people may remember from the anime, which I think will be great for longtime fans.
そうですね、このグラフィックスの表現がやはり過去のあのアニメに似たような印象が強いですね。それは長年のポケモンファンにとっては懐かしいんじゃないでしょうか。
そうですね。もともとピカチュウ版をベースにしてるっていうのもあるんですけど、この主人公がもう肩にピカチュウ乗せてるのがもうサトシと冒険してるみたいな感じもありますし、やはりそのポケモンたちとどうのように出会っていくかっていうのも、まあ、ちょっとこうなんていうんですね、アニメとか、今までの、そういったシリーズ、皆さんをずっと気にかけてくれていたその多くの、まあ、映画であるとかカードであるとか、さまざまなものがこう混ざってるような感じにしています。
Yeah, there's definitely that aspect. Of course, Pikachu being on your shoulder maybe even makes you feel a little bit like Ash from the animated series. In these games, it's not just the animated series, though. We've really tried to take an amalgamation of the different expressions that you see in the card game, for example, definitely through the animated series and the animated movies, and really just trying to express that through how the Pokemon move about and how you encounter them in the game.
So I say we're in another wild Pokemon battle with Teresa doing an underthrow there. Mm-hmm. 今の野生のポケモンの、あの、捕まえる画面でアンダースローをしましたね。
テレサがしてくれましたね。
Yeah, you did a good job there.
Thank you.
ありがとうございます。
あの、最初にボタンを押して、ジョイコンの、ジャイロの部分を一回リセットしてます。なので、一回ボタンを押して振るんですけども、まあ、このなんかジョイコンをどこでリセットするかによっていろんなテクニックもあったりするので、ぜひいろいろ試してほしいなと思います。
It's a bit technical about how you can actually change your throwing technique, but when you press the kind of a get in position button, it resets the gyro position. So from there is where it thinks is kind of the normal position, and that doing that, depending on where you're holding the controller at the time, can allow you to do a variety of different things.
But of course, when you can also play the game handheld mode if you decide to take it off the TV, and in that case, you're able to play with button controls, correct?
で、あの、もちろんテレビじゃなくても、まあ、スイッチですので、ハンドヘルドで遊べることもできますし、
はい、
で、その場合はボタン操作になりますよね。
そうですね。あの、思ってですね、本体ジャイロで、こう、本体ジャイロというか、まあ、本体を動かして、遊ぶような。仕組みにしてます。その場合はまあボタンを押して、的をポケモンに合わせて B ボタンを押してボールを飛ばすというふうにしています。
In handheld mode, it's a slightly different style of gameplay where you're actually taking the entire system itself and using the gyro inside of that. You press the button to get in position, and then there's a target that appears, and you've got to align that with the Pokemon, and then get your timing right, press the button to throw out the Pokeball.
Yeah. So, but I think we also have...another mode that perhaps we wanted to talk about that also takes advantage of the Switch and a second Joy-Con. で、まあ今日はあのもうちょっと話をしたかったもう一つのモードがありますよね。
はい。
もう一つのジョイコンを使うオプションですね。
はい。あのフィールド中に、右下にですね、グリーンの、なんていうんですかね、マークが出てるんですけども、それが出てるときは、2P 側で、振ることで。もう一人のサポートのトレーナーが現れるようになります。
In the bottom right of the screen, or actually in the right of the screen in the battle mode, you may have just seen that, but it indicates that you can have a second player join your game simply by shaking the second controller, the second Joy-Con.
出ましたね。あれました。
And there, and then there's the port support character.
So I am now playing together with Teresa. で、僕がテレサさんと二人で今遊んでます。
はい。これあの息を合わせて、ボールを投げると、これチャレンジですね。
Yeah. Give it a try. Try getting into full synchronization here and align with each other throwing these Pokeballs.
All right, challenge accepted.
Okay.
Ready, Bill?
はい、チャレンジは受け取ります。はい。
Okay. On three.
One, two, three.
Oh!
Nice!
Very good.
素晴らしい、素晴らしい。
That was a good throw.
相性がいいですね。
相性いいですね。
We get along well.
Good synergy.
Oh, 出てきた。
We were too soon. 言うのが早かったですね。
Alright, let's try again.
One, two, three.
おい、2回連続すごいですね。
Two in a row, perfect.
Nice!
Oh, nice!
Yeah.
Did it.
Nice, isn't it?
I do want to make a comment, though, that in the TV show, there were a lot of Pokemon trainers that were able to catch Pokemon without battling them, so you kind of get that sense here with the wild Pokemon encounters. It's really a cool simulation.
まあそうですね、先ほどアニメの話は出ましたけれども、はい、アニメの中には、バトルせずに野生のポケモンを捕まえたトレーナーたちはいましたので、うん
はい、
やっぱりそういう実感もこのゲームではできますよね。
そうですね、あのボールをいかにこう、楽しく投げるかっていうのが遊びの一つにしてます。
Yeah, really how you throw out that Pokeball, that's really the entire experience of, you know, catching Pokemon in this game, so we definitely put a lot of care into that.
Yeah, so actually why don't we do a battle, a trainer battle.
Okay.
We're gonna try to dodge all of these Pokemon. They're swarming today.
Pokemon, 一応トレーナーバトルやってみたいと思うんですけれども、
はい、
ポケモンが結構多いですね。
そうなんですよ。ここはわらわら
ポケモンがいる場所なんで。
Yeah, and then Viridian Forest in particular, there's just a ton of Pokemon kind of walking around the grass, you can see.
So in a trainer battle, both players get to battle as well, and that can be a big help for somebody who's more of a novice player.
The trainer battle では協力プレイの場合は2人でも、バトルができますよね。これは初心者に向いては結構いいんですよね。
そうですね。やっぱりリビングでプレイしてる時に誰か見つけて、プレイしてる人をちょっとサポートしてみようかなって思ったり、一緒に、楽しめるように、今回してます。
I think it's going to be a lot of fun if players are in their living room playing on their TVs and someone maybe comes in. You can just quickly join in the game and enjoy the experience together.
Today, the music is the first time of the red and red era of the music to be more classic.テレビで、聞いても非常に高音質で楽しめるようにしてます。
We really took the original music from the Red and Blue games and kind of that really that classic take, but made them in really high fidelity this time around, so you can even really enjoy listening it to your big screen TV, for example.
Yeah, well, I have always been a fan, Masuda-san, of your work on the music in the Pokemon series, so I'm very excited to be able to experience that in my living room.
僕はもう長い間、Masuda-san の、今までポケモンシリーズで作ってきた音楽の大ファンなので、
はい、
ソファに座ってリビングでそれが聞こえるっていうのがすごい楽しみです。
Same for me. Like the last time I played a Pokemon game, and I'm embarrassed to admit that it was back in the Game Boy era. So this is super nostalgic for me. I'm really excited to play it completely.
そうですね。テレサさんは当時のポケモンファンで、このようにまあ当時の遊びがまたテレビで遊べるっていうのがすごい、懐かしさがありますね。
良いですね。なんかそうなんですよ。当時のファンの子たちもそうですし。当時の子だと大体なんとなくこう冒険の、どう進めたらいいかっていうのは分かると思うんで、初めてポケモンをプレイする人と一緒に、なんていうんですかね、こうガイドじゃないですけど、一緒に楽しめるっていうふうにできるといいなっていうふうに思ってます。
I think one fun aspect of that is for players who maybe enjoyed the original generation of Pokemon games, they'll generally know how the adventure goes in these games and be able to kind of give maybe advice or help maybe guide some of the younger players who may be enjoying these for the first time.
And it looks like Teresa has decided to swap out her Pokemon.
Teresa-san がパートナーポケモンは違うものにしようと。
でかいの乗りましたね、いわく。
Jumped on a big Onyx there, that's for sure.
Yeah, it's really cool that this game really does show Pokemon in their true scale format. So it's really interesting to see this tinier, smaller Pokemon versus the ever majestic Onyx.
そうですね。今回のソフトはポケモンの本当の規模を表してますので、ああいうちっちゃいポケモンとでっかいポケモンの違いを見せるっていうのがすごい面白いですね。
はい。やっぱりでかいと乗りたくなるんですよね。
I think when the Pokemon are that big, you really just kind of as a player want to ride them.
Yeah.
で結構マルマインだと転がったりとか、結構アイデアとかをモーションデザイナーの人たちがいろいろ作ってくれました。
But you're going to see that our animators got really creative with some of the Pokemon. For example, like Electrode, instead of walking, it's going to be rolling behind you like a ball.
So it looks like we've gotten out of Viridian Forest and we have now come to Pewter City.
で今はTokiwa の森を出て、Nibi City に来ましたよね。
So who is this character that we're seeing?
今のキャラクターは誰でしょうか？
これライバルですね。今作プレイヤーもそうですけど、主人公もそうですけど、ピカチュウ版の当時のそれとはちょっと違う、キャラクターを登場させてます。
So this is actually the rival in these games, and you'll see that it's different than the rival that appeared in Pokemon Yellow version, which these games are based off of. There's a lot of other differences in the characters as well.
彼はライバルなんですけど、結構親切で、時に怖がったりするんですけど、ちょっとどこで怖がるかお楽しみにしてもらえればと思います。
But you'll see, even though we're technically calling it your rival, he's actually quite kind to you. Of course, he has other personality traits, like he gets scared very easily. And I think you're going to have fun seeing in which situations he gets scared at.
まあ、こうしてあのキャラクターにこう変化を、まあ、新しいキャラクターを登場させることで、あの新しいこうイベントを作ったりということもしています。
So we've added some new events to the games compared to the originals and also changed up the characters a bit to make them kind of feel fresh.
That's great. Well, Teresa, since we just went through Viridian Forest and had a few battles, maybe we should go to the Pokemon Center and heal our Pokemon.
That's probably a good call.
ええー、まああの東京の森でいろいろバトルしてきましたので、はい、ポケモンセンターで、oh. ちょっと回復した方がいいんじゃないでしょうか。
まあもうおなじみのポケモンセンターです。
It's a pretty familiar location for fans, I think.
I like how Pikachu jumps off your shoulder. ここでピカチュウが肩からカウンターに乗るっていうのがすごい可愛いですね。
はい。あと今お気づきの方いらっしゃったかもしれないですけど、ドット絵でちょっとあの表現していたりと。
You may have seen in the Pokemon Center, we made sure to keep the original pixel art, not the original, but the pixel art for the Pokemon appearing on the screen there.
やっぱりね、3D になってもなんかドット絵ってやっぱりね、いいんですよね。
A game for Gorilla loves the pixel art. Even if we go to 3D, we still want to keep them in the game.
That's right.
あとこうやってあの街の中にもこうポケモンと一緒にこういる人がいますね。
You see lots of residents of the town walking around living with their Pokemon.
Yeah, and the town looks great.本当に街が、うん、あのすごい出来がいいですね。
はい、建物も、まあ、あの再度やっぱりデザイナーが全部設計し直してますね。
And all the buildings have been redesigned by all of our graphic designers.
And you were mentioning the townspeople with their Pokemon. で、その村人とポケモンがあちこちにいますけれども。
はい。
This is
これヤドン、ヤドンですね。
That's a slow poke as you can see.
今まで、まあ、そのピカチュウベースなんですけど、こういったイベントはもともとはなかったものですね。
So these kind of little events we've peppered throughout the game that weren't in the original Pokemon Yellow version.
まあ特にあのこうしてフィールドに一緒にポケモンがいるっていうのが、まあ、一緒にみんなで生活している感じっていうのが出せて、まあ、非常に楽しめると思います。
Part of this was to really increase that feeling of humans and Pokemon living together in the same world.
It's also very interesting that the world has encouraged for the player to interact with the world because you never know what's going to happen. It's really exciting.
まあそうですね。あとはこの今回の世界が本当にプレイヤーがいろんなものとインタラクションをしてどういう結果を出るかっていうのは楽しみですね。
そうですね。ちょっと今ヤドン、ヤドンらしい、
pretty slow poke like thing to do there, I think.
Well, perhaps we should take the advice of our rival and head toward the gym.
Yeah, sure. That sounds great.
では、あの、ライバルのアドバイスを受けて、はい、ジムの方に向かっていきましょうか。
はい。
Let's do it.
ここは今度のジムですね。
This is the gym, obviously.
Wow, the gyms have really changed in design. ジムのデザインはかなり変わりましたね。
はい、あの元々のベースは一緒なんですけど、あのなんていうんですかね、よりこうこの場所にジムがあったときにみんなこう観客がやっぱりいるんじゃないかとか、少しこう膨らませています。この他にもあのジムによっては、まあ、オリジナルの、まあ、ピカチュウバージョンとは違うジムもあったりします。
When making these games on Switch, you know, bringing the region to the Switch games, we took the original gyms as a base, but then thought what we could add onto it to kind of enrich the visuals and everything. We felt that, hey, for this gym, you'd probably be some spectator seats, but depending on which gym you go to, it may even be completely different from the Pokemon Yellow version.
これ今水タイプか草タイプどっちか持ってますかって聞かれたんですけど。
So the guy was asking you if you had a water or grass type Pokemon.、はい
And so we're getting close to Brock, who appears in this game. やはりあのたけしに向かっていますけれども。
まあね、岩といえばたけしですよね。
With rock types, you know, it's all about Brock, right?
Yes, and we do see that we have some very fun lines from the past game as well.
過去のソフトからのセリフも。はい、これはね。あの変えられないですね、こういう大事なセリフの人たちは。
Yeah, some of those lines you really just can't change.
They're too iconic. I'd be sad if they weren't there.
そうですよね、あのなかったらなんかかっかりしますよね。
そうなんですよ、そうなんですよ。
That's right.
自分たちも作っててやっぱり、うん、これ消せないだろうっていうのがいっぱいありますんで。
And not just for the fans, but as creators ourselves, you know, we're making the games like, yeah, we can't get rid of this. We gotta keep it as it was.
let's. Oh, nice.
Hmm.
All right, you're good. No pressure.
やっぱり2人でバトルするっていうのは良いですね。便利ですね。It's nice to be, be able to battle together.
The other really cool thing too is that not just with the trainer battles, but also the Pokemon encounters, you can feel everything, every interaction through the Joy-Con. It's really satisfying and really immersive experience.
そうですね、やはりあの、まあ、トレーナーバトルだけじゃなくてどんなインタラクションでもやっぱり、ジョイコンの振動で体感できます、はい、でそれがすごい気持ちいいんですね、
はい、あのブルブルっと技を受けた時とかもブルブルってするんで、あのこれもジョイコンのやっぱり機能の素晴らしいところだと思ったんで取り入れてます、
yeah, We really thought that the HD rumble in the Joy-Con is a really cool technology. We put a lot of care into making it feel good, like when there's maybe you get attacked, it rumbles a little bit and it feels like you know, you're getting hit almost.
もう本当にスイッチの性能全部活かしてますね。
はい。
Really using all of the features of Nintendo Switch.
And here is Brock. You made it.
皆さんおなじみの
Brock that everyone is familiar with, I think.
At this point, we kind of want to move topics, switch gears, and talk about something else.
That's right. ではあの実演プレイは、はい、ちょっと休憩をして、はい、別のトピックに移しますけれども。
はい。
So we've been playing with the Joy-Con, but of course the game is also compatible with a special new controller, the Pokeball Plus. 今まではあの Joy-Con で遊んでいましたけれども、実はあのもう一つの特別なコントローラー対応してますよね。はいモンスターボールプラスですね。
はい。
And the Pokeball Plus, it acts as a Joy-Con. It has all the functionality. It's got a control stick that you can press down, and even a button on the top. で、まあ、本当にあの Joy-Con そのものの機能も入ってますし、操作スティックもあって、それも押し込むことができますし、はい、上にボタンがありますよね。
これあの振動もまたこう特別な振動になっていて、よりあの振動力が強い。
You actually see that the rumble in the Pokeball Plus is even stronger than a typical Joy-Con, so it's a kind of a special experience.
で今回あのJoy-Conを、あ、Joy-Conじゃない、このモンスターボールプラスをあの買った時にですね、最初にこう何にも入ってないモンスターボールってちょっと寂しいなと思って、もっとワクワクしたいなと思ったんで、あの最初にちょっと何入れたらいいかなと思って、なんかポケモン入れておきたいなと思ったんですけど、まあ、いろいろ考えてあのミュウを最初に入れて、なのでお店で買って家に帰るまでこうミュウがキュキュ言ってるっていう状況になりますんで、あのこのプレゼントをみんなに喜んでもらえたらなと思ってます。
We were making the Pokeball Plus. We knew we were gonna, you know, it was gonna come out, but we felt that if it was empty when you bought it, you'd feel kind of lonely. So we were thinking of Pokemon to put inside of the Pokeball Plus and players first get it andDeciding which Pokemon to put in there, we just came down to Mew, you know, the mythical Pokemon Mew. That'd be the most appropriate. So when players go to the store and they're on their way back home with it, they'll be able to kind of hear Mew cry from inside of the ball, and it'll be an interesting experience.
That's right. So then you can transfer that Mew into your game, and you can also put other Pokemon into the Pokeball and take them with you when you go out on a walk. And then based on your movement and your activity, you can then get presents in the game when you bring the Pokemon back.でまあ、あのおっしゃったように、はい、この中にポケモンが入ることができて、で、まあ、ミュウは、ソフトに転送することもできますし、
はい、
でソフトからの別のポケモンもどのポケモンでもここに転送することができて、
はい、
散歩に出て、その動きをベースにあの戻ってくるときにまた何かプレゼントがもらえますよね。
そうですね。ちょっといいことがありますけども、あの相棒、これ今相棒入ってると思うんですけど、
そうですね、
はい、泣くかな。
Maybe hear your partner cry out here.
And I have to, I'm shaking it up to close to my mic so everyone can hear. Mic の近くに振って。見てる皆さんが聞こえます。
Evie,
yeah.
But what I really like about the Pokeball Plus controller is the weight, the size, and actually just it feels so good. あの、この僕が結構気に入ってるのがやっぱりこの、このサイズとこの重さとこの表面の感触が、
そうなんですよ、感触いいんですよね。
そうですよね、
はい、yeah, the feel of the Pokeball Plus is really nice.
でこの LED もいろんな色になるんで、あのポケモンのちょっとこうタイプというかあれですね、ポケモンのちょっとカラーに合わせて光ったりもしますんで。
The LED light that you can see at the where the joystick is actually lights up in a really wide variety of colors, and it kind of corresponds with the type of the Pokemon that's inside of it.
But then of course you can also connect it to your cell phone and use it as a Pokemon Go Plus and play Pokemon Go. And interact with Pokestops and catch Pokemon just using this without taking your phone out as well. で、携帯にも接続して、はい、無線で接続して、ポケモン GO プラスとして使えることもできますよね。
はい、できますね。あのポケモン GO とあの連携すると、このポケモン GO プラスというモンスターボールプラス。
So yeah, it's a Pokeball Plus, but when you connect with Pokemon Go, it works as a Pokemon Go Plus.
That's right. So lots of functionality. 本当にあのいろんな使い方がありますね。
はい、これ楽しめると思います。
はい。
So beyond just sharing your adventure with another player to play co-op, you're also able to battle and trade with other players. Maybe Mr. Masuda has more information on that feature.
はい、まあ、先ほどあの協力プレイを見せたんですけれども、はい、それ以外に、実際にあのプレイヤーと、バトルとか、はい、ポケモンの交換もできますよね。
はい、あの今回あの通信交換、についてあの映像をご用意したので、それをお見せしつつご説明したいと思います。
They've actually brought a video to show off some of the link trade and battle aspects.
Great, let's take a look at the video.じゃあビデオを見てみましょう。
はい、ここですね。ワイヤレスですね。まあローカル通信とインターネット通信っていうのを使用しまして、シングルバトル、ダブルバトル交換を楽しむことができます。
As you can see, you can use either local wireless or connect over the internet to play, do link trades or do single battle and double battle battles against friends and other players.
で今こうポケモンが出てますけど。通信に関してこのポケモンアイコンを選んでその組み合わせがパスワードとなってマッチングが成立するようになってます。
And you saw on screen there it said link code, and what that is pretty much a matchmaking password. You choose a combination of Pokemon and are matched up with other players who chose the same combination.
なので友達と、ピカチュウ、イーブイ、不思議だねって決めてですね、交換することができますね。
So you tell your friend, okay, pick Pikachu, Bulbasaur andEevee, and then we'll be able to connect and trade together or battle together.
で、ポケモンを選んで、
交換画面に、you're able to go into the trading sequence.
よ、バイバイロコン。
See you later, Vulpix.
これはまあ昔のあのケーブル時代のイメージを。デジタルケーブルにしてます。
You can see that animation is kind of reminiscent of the maybe the link cable that you had to use to trade Pokemon back then. We just kind of digitized that into a cool trading sequence.
やっぱね、あのケーブル楽しかったですからね。
Yeah, we just have good memories, fond memories of trading with that link cable.
Great. But of course, not only can you trade Pokemon with other players, but you can also connect with Pokemon Go, and you can send Pokemon from Pokemon Go into Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee, correct? で、これはもちろん、あの、まあ、他のプレイヤーとポケモンの交換はできますけれども、はい、それ以外にも、ポケモン Go に接続して、はい、ポケモン Go からポケモンをLet's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee に配信することができますよね。
はい、そうですね。あの、送ることができるようになってます。まあ、Go Park という場所がありますので、そちらも見てみたいと思います。
Yeah, there's actually a location that facilitates that called Go Park, and hopefully we can show off a little bit of what that is.
ここは昔のサファリゾーンがあった、ピカチュウ版だとサファリゾーンなんですよね。
So,Pokemon Yellow version, there was the Safari Zone, but Go Park actually is in that same location, replaces it.
ここで、Pokemon の Go Park の方に行くことができます。
And from there, at the reception, you can choose which Go Park to go into.
で、この場所であのアローラの姿を含めた関東地方のポケモンが、レッツゴピカチュウ、レッツゴイブイに持ってくることができます。
You can bring from Pokemon Go any of the Kanto region Pokemon, including their Alolan variants, and transfer them to the game, and they'll appear in Go Park here.
This looks like a fun place for the Pokemon. なんかポケモンにとってはとても 楽しいところみたいですね。
あのいろんなここで行動しますので、あのなんですかね、こう家にポケモンがいる、まあ、テレビでずっとその映像を映しておくだけでも楽しいと思います。
Yeah, and you'll see them just running around doing little fun movements in here. So I think maybe just using it as like a screensaver for your TV could be kind of fun, just to see the Pokemon moving around in your house almost.
And so once you've sent a Pokemon from Pokemon Go here to Go Park, then how do you bring it into the game?
で、Pokemon Go からここの Go Park に転送した後に、ゲームに持ってくるには、
はい、
そうですね、どうするんですか？
これあの、このポケモンと話しかけてですね、Go Park の方にこれですね。
So you talk to the Pokemon, and then
これで、今度は捕獲画面になりますので、ここで捕まえることで、レッツゴーピカチュウ、レッツゴーイブイで使えるようになると。
So after talking to him, they're able to choose the catch option, which brings it into the catching or encounter screen. And if you catch them, then they're joining your party, pretty much.
なので、ちょっと CP が高いポケモン GO の、ポケモンを持ってきていると、レベルが高い、高めなものになったりするので。
And you'll see if you transfer over Pokemon from Pokemon GO that have a really high CP level, they'll appear in Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee at a pretty much a higher level, they'll be stronger.
So that will make them harder to capture. ということは、捕まえにくくなりますよね。
若干。
A little bit.
あとはやっぱり、まあ、自分がポケモン GO を例えばしてたとしましても、まあ、持ってるポケモンってある程度限られるので、友達からもどんどんもらえるように、なっていますので、まあ、親であったり友達であったりいろんな人からこうポケモン GO のポケモンを集めるっていう楽しみ方もできます。
And you can receive Pokemon from Pokemon Go. It doesn't matter whose Pokemon Go it is. You can get them from friends, maybe a parent or grandparents.You can get a whole bunch of different Pokemon from Pokemon Go and see what they're like in Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee.
And when you send the Pokemon from Pokemon Go to Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee, they leave your Pokemon Go and in exchange you would get some candies.
でその場合はやっぱりポケモン GO からそのポケモンがもういなくなって、ピカチュウ、イービーの方に行って、ポケモン GO から転送した人がキャンディーがもらえることですよね。
はい、そうなんです。今回育成のシステムを少し変えまして、ポケモン博士に送ると、
Yeah. We've actually introduced a new system. In addition to what you just said, we've introduced a new system to strengthen Pokemon with candy and Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee.
これは今あれですね、はい、ちょっとこれに育成システムを、はい、スライドをちょっと用意しました。
And we've got, a couple of slides just to show off what that actually, how that actually works.
はい、これ今ちょうどプロフェッサーに送るとこですね。
So you can see on this screen here, it gives you the option to send to professor.
はい、で、まあ、オーキド博士に送ることで、まあ、そのポケモンの送った数によって飴をもらうことができます。
And by depending on the number of Pokemon you actually send to Professor Oak, with this option, you're able to get a variety of candy.
今これクイックキャンディーになってますね。
So this one is a quick candy you saw on screen there.
はい。で、まあこの飴をポケモンに与えることによって強さを高めることができます。
And by giving these candy to your Pokemon, you're able to power up their different stats.
そういう意味でこう今までの本編とはちょっと違う今作ならではの違ったポケモンの育て方を楽しんでもらいたいなと思ってます。
So this way to strengthen your Pokemon, it's a system that's kind of unique to Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee. You didn't really see it in the other games.
Well, and what it also means is that as you're playing through the game and you're having those wild Pokemon encounters and you're able to capture lots of wild Pokemon, there's actually a way that that builds back into the gameplay.
で、まあその野生のポケモンをどんどん捕まえることができるんですけれども、はい、その、どんどん捕まえる上でやっぱり使い道があるっていう、まあ、ルーゲームプレイのサイクルにも関係がありますよね、
はい、今回はもうとにかくポケモンいっぱい捕まえてほしいっていうポケモンをこのレッツゴーピカチュウイブイにいっぱい集めてほしいっていうのがありますので、そういう。
So, yeah, and as you can see, I mean, I've been showing that all these different ways we want to make players just catch more and more Pokemon, and this is just another incentive to do that. And let's go Pikachu and let's go Eevee.
Well, that's great. I mean, I'm personally very excited to be able to not only sit down and play Pokemon on my TV, but also to be able to play co-op with my own daughter and introduce her to the Pokemon series as well. まあ、僕自身はあのやはりポケモンレッツゴーピカチュウレッツゴーイービーでテレビの前で座って遊べるっていうのも楽しみなんですけれども、はい、自分の娘と一緒に、まあ、ポケモンシリーズの紹介をぜひしたいと思ってますので、
多分、ルートはどう行けばどう冒険すればいいかはもう素晴らしいトレーナーなので分かってると思うんで。
Bill, you're an amazing Pokemon trainer, so I think you'll be able to give some tips to your daughter about how, where to go and how to play.
Yeah, so it should be fun. 楽しみにしてます。はい。So I think we're getting towards the end of our gameplay today, but I wanted to give Mr. Masuda a chance to say deliver any last messages to all of our fans. じゃあ今日の実演プレイはまあ、大体これで終わりになるんですけれども、はいはい、増田さんの方から、まあ、最後の一言は何かメッセージはありますでしょうか。
あのまず1個あって、現在のレッツゴーピカチュウレッツゴーイーブイのこの E3 の、出展を記念してですね、ポケモン GO でこの E3 の期間中ですね、レッツゴーびっくり、LETSGO びっくりマークのアンノーンと、ピカチュウ EV があのロサンゼルス市内に登場します。
So one fun thing I have to announce for players in the general vicinity or here at the show is that to kind of celebrate our the show and also being able to have Pikachu, or I mean Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee on display here at E3, we're going to have Pikachu, Eevee and Let's Go, the unknown characters, unknown, the Pokemon that resemble LETSGO and the exclamation mark appear in the LA area, so go out and catch them if you can.
Well, that's great because I am very short on my, my unknowns in Pokemon Go. それはあの僕はあの unknown をあんまり捕まえてないので、Go で、なのですごい。
ぜひ捕まえてください。
はい、ありがとうございます。
はい、であの今回あの本編、やっぱりこう楽しんでくれてた今までのファンの子たちと、してまあこうしてポケモン Go で、まあ、多くポケモンを知ってもらったので、あのそれぞれがあの一緒になってさらにこのポケモンを盛り上げて、みんなのポケモンっていうことで一緒に遊んで楽しんでもらえたらなというふうに思ってます。
And I keep saying a Pokemon for everyone with Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee, and what I really mean by that is that with Pokemon Go there are so many new players are experiencing Pokemon for the first time, but of course our longtime fans who have loved Pokemon games, you know, for over all these years are extremely important to us. With these games, I'm really hoping that I can kind of bring them together and get everyone to really enjoy Pokemon.
That sounds like a very good goal. とても素敵な目的ですね。
はい。
Well, thank you very much for joining us today. It's been a lot of fun. 今朝は本当にあの楽しかったです。どうもありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。
Nintendo Treehouse Live will continue after a short break. We've got more games to come, and I'd like to thank everybody for tuning in.
では、but we have maybe one more announcement to make.
Oh, that's right. I was forgetting. もうあの終わるところでしたけれども、もう一つあの言わなきゃいけないことがあります。I forgot to mention that this morning we did announce that in addition to Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee and the Pokeball Plus, Nintendo will also be offering a special bundle version that includes the game and the Pokeball Plus controller. あのまあポケモンレッツゴーイービーの、ソフトと、ポケモンレッツゴーピカチュウのソフトと、モンスターボールプラスのコントローラーがありますけれども、今朝あの発表されたのが、ソフトと、モンスターボールプラスの同梱版のパッケージも用意してます。
おお、一緒に一緒に冒険だ。
That's right, you can go on an adventure together. So
Yeah.
Great, thank you everybody
awesome.
for yeah, tuning in and we will be back shortly. 皆さん、あの、見ていただいてどうもありがとうございます。この後ツリーハウスライブの配信は続きますけれども、あの、申し訳ないんですがこの後英語のみになります。それでは皆さんありがとうございました。
Hey everybody, and welcome back to Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3. I'm Sam, joined by my colleague Kirk down at the end, who's going to be helping us out with some gameplay this segment. And we've got some very special guests joining us right now. Here I have Eric, Ariane, and Nick from Epic Games, who are going to hang out with us and play a little Fortnite Battle Royale. And thank you so much, guys, for coming by and spending some time with us today.
We're super excited. It's fantastic to have Fortnite on the Switch, and so we're so excited to be here.
So as we're getting in here, Nick and Kirk are going to be doing some gameplay. But for folks who are watching who maybe haven't had a chance to jump into Fortnite Battle Royale before, we should probably kick off with a really quick intro to what this game is all about.
Yeah, sure. So the basic premise of Fortnite is you and 100 other people are dropped onto an island, and the last man standing wins. And so you use any tools at your dispersion to basically figure out a way to be that last person standing, whether it's weapons or special items or building a really cool base. We have all kinds of really fun and exciting tools to use to be that last person standing.
Well, we're incredibly happy to have you with us on Nintendo Switch, and we'll be able to hop into some gameplay here, show some stuff, fine dance moves going on here. Excellent work, guys.
So one of the really cool things about Fortnite is how fun and sort of lighthearted it is. And you can see as they're queuing up for a match right now, they're showing off some of their emotes. And those emotes are, they range from dances to throwing up, you know, communications to your friends and other things like that. So right now what's happening is they're loading into the match, and they'll start out on the loading island for a brief period of time. After that, they're going to take the battle bus across the island, choose a point to drop into the match and start looting up and start figuring out what exactly they want to do to win.
And of course, this is live online gameplay, so we're not really sure what we're going to see here, who's going to come in and pay our guys a visit, but really looking forward to seeing how things shape up. So as we're getting kind of comfortable here started, we should probably go over some of the HUD elements for folks who aren't familiar with Fortnite to let them know what they're looking at.
Yep, so the in the bottom middle, you've got your health bar, which is basically shows you how much life you have available. You can see there's 100 life and up to 100 shield. If you find various shield potions or other shield items throughout the world, those will allow you to gain more health.
And
now, as you can see,
ready.
They're moving across the map. They're going to dive in. At the top right, you've got basically what we call a mini map, and that shows you where you are. Top left, you've got the team. You've got the team list of your people you're playing with, and then in the bottom right, once they jump off the bus, you'll see that they've got an inventory, basic items that they can carry. Everyone starts with a pickaxe. This is a big part of Fortnite's gameplay, is that you can destroy a lot of the objects around the world. So destroying those objects will get you different resources, such as wood, stone, or metal. And then with those resources, you can build different objects. So you can build a wall, you can build a ramp, you can build a floor. And those can be used in a variety of different ways. If you want to be, you know, if you just want to be mobile and get around the map to go up a cliff or down a cliff, you want to build a wall for some cover if somebody's shooting at you. These are all sort of the on-the-fly choices that you can make.
And I think we'll be able to see a lot more of crafting as we get into the game here. But right now, right at the start, there's a pretty big strategic decision you have to make as far as where you're going to land on the map.
Exactly. So it looks like in this match, we're jumping in, starting somewhere a little more remote, so maybe we won't find other players. Some of the more, you'll see on the map, has some of the what we call points of interest or different city locations. And generally, those are a little bit more populated. So you've got, you know, Dusty Divot in the middle or Tilted Towers over to the left. And they've jumped to Junk Junction, which is in sort of the northwest quadrant. It's a little bit further away from stuff and gives them the ability to hopefully gather some equipment without any harm.
And this is available on the Nintendo eShop right now for Nintendo Switch. So hopefully we'll be running into some other folks who are playing on Switch here as well. And oh, I got some good gear going there. I do love that when you're first getting started, you really have to decide, okay, are you prioritizing collecting materials, gathering weapons? You know, really, what's your approach going to be? And maybe you want to be somewhere more populated so you can try to secure some quick kills. But on the other hand, maybe you want to get out here a little bit further away, build up some resources, and then start trying to approach other players.
That's right. And we try to promote as many different styles of play as possible. And so for some players, Tilted Towers is a location that's generally pretty populated because there's a lot of loot there. If you're a more aggressive player, you can go there, and the likelihood of finding another player is very, very high.
So just thinking of other strategic elements that folks are going to want to keep in mind as, oh, see a vending machine there.
So vending machines are an item that we added a little while ago that allows you to trade in your resources for... Looks like they're doing a laugh emote. you can trade in resources for different types of items. And if you whack it with your pickaxe, it'll kind of cycle through the different items that are available. So if you don't find a gun that you might, you know, that you're interested in, this would give you an opportunity or an option to acquire it through a different means. So you can see there is this golden chest. So all around the map are chests randomly placed in various locations, and they're always guaranteed to drop at least one weapon, some ammo, a consumable of some sort, and that's kind of, you know, in the early starting game, something that you really want to seek out.
And they do have a pretty specific sound effect, a distinct sound to listen for, so if you're checking out some basements and attics and you're not sure whether or not there's a chest there, the audio is very important. You want to be paying attention for that cue to say, okay, there's a chest nearby. You should spend a little bit more time searching for it.
That's right, and it's got kind of a bit of a glowing sound, so you can kind of hear where it is. Now, if you look at the map, you can see we've got about a minute and 10 seconds before that first storm circle is going to start to close. And this is a really big part of Fortnite gameplay, is over time, the storm circles close in and force players closer and closer together. Now, an average match is around 20 minutes if you make it all the way to the end. So it's a nice, quick, digestible format. And you'll see that they've got a little ways to go. So it's forcing all of the remaining players. You can see it just trickled down in the top right there from about 60 to 57 players. You can watch that trickle down as players are slowly eliminated. But they're running basically back to the playable circle as the storm closes in so that they can stay safe.
Yes, you certainly can. You hang out in the storm a little bit if you want to, but your health is going to be depleting constantly as you're out there. It's an incredibly dangerous place, and your vision is also obscured when you're looking into the storm as well. So you're very vulnerable if you spend time in the storm. You really don't want to be there unless you're like, oh, I was just a little too late getting here. I really need to get myself back to safety.
Yep, that's absolutely right. And the first storm circles are a little bit, they don't do quite as much damage as the later storm circles because obviously you've got a long distance to travel. We want to allow people to, you know, if they make a little bit of a mistake, they can catch up. But as the game progresses, that storm will get stronger and stronger.
Oh, there we go. So storm is shrinking.
Yep, and so they've got 3 minutes to get back to the safe zone, which should be plenty of time. And you can see, some combat to the right.
I do love the strategy when you're playing with a partner or a team, trying to like build up some protection around you, but in that case somebody snuck up and that did not work out.
Yep, looks like Shadow Potato 923 wins today, but
bravo Shadow Potato.
So one of the strategies there with when you're playing with a friend is if one of you gets knocked down, you go into what we call a down but not out state. So you're not immediately eliminated from the match. They can come to you and revive you. So one of the other things that we've got you're looking at here is there's a whole lot of player customization options in Fortnite. This is huge for us. We think it's really important to be able to express yourself with a variety of different skins, emotes, what we call back bling. It's kind of a backpack accessory. And some other basic customization options that really allow you to choose who you want to be.
And actually, this is probably a really good chance for us to start talking about V-Bucks and Seasons as well and how that kind of works into the Fortnite dynamic.
That's right. So our currency that you can use to purchase the Battle Pass is called it's called V-Bucks. And the Battle Pass will allow you to, if you purchase it, will allow you to basically unlock different cosmetic items through play. So we give you weekly challenges, such as eliminating other players with a certain weapon type or finding some kind of unique objects around the world, and those will give you experience to unlock these different levels and then get those cosmetics. And so we think this is a really great value for our players. Every season we introduce new skins. They are exclusive to that season and we'll never sell them again. So if you're, you know, if there's something in that really piques your interest, now's the time to act because it's not going to come back for the next season.
And I will say, I do really appreciate that. I mean, you guys have been so robust in your approach to updates and new content, making sure there's always fresh stuff there for the player. But it's not pay to win. So there's a lot of, you know, expressing your personal style and your personality and your play style, but it doesn't feel like, oh, you know, if I don't buy, you know, this weapon or this item, I'm going to be non-competitive for a while.
That's right. That's a huge deal to us, is making sure that our cosmetics are entirely cosmetic only. And they're not going to affect gameplay. They're not going to give you any advantage. But they do allow you to customize your character, right? We think that's really, really important for the competitive aspect of the game, and to keep that integrity of, you know, the best player wins.
You guys have put some pretty fun stuff into the recent updates, I will say. It's been a lot of fun to see that stuff get into play.
Yep, so this week we just released the thermal scoped assault rifle. It allows you to see enemies at a distance that kind of stand out. It does a kind of color effect that allows you to see enemy players and treasure chests and supply drops. Makes it just much easier to see stuff. In the past, we've added things like shopping carts that you can use to get around the map and do cool sort of jumps and tricks, as well as a bunch of different weapon types and consumables.
Yeah, I think the shopping cart's one of my personal favorites, and coming back to that idea of this being a very lighthearted, kind of fun experience, it really kind of changes the mood. We're in the middle of a firefight, and suddenly somebody YOLOs through with a shopping cart, and just like, all right, hi, what's going on? Over a ramp you go, but there are some folks who jump in here to play, and they're not necessarily focused on being the last player standing. For them, it's more about the construction or the crazy jumps and just having a really fun time with the physics in this world, because it's just a blast running around and bouncing off things and seeing what kind of crazy structures you can make.
Yeah, that's right. So in every match, you know, 99 people are going to lose, or when you're playing solo at least, and that means only one person wins. So it's really important to us that it still feels fun and that you have a good time, even if you're eliminated.
So over here we've got Nick playing on the TV with a docked Switch, but we do have Kirk over on the end playing in handheld mode. Yep. Can we talk a little bit about how it was getting the handheld experience together?
Yeah, so we've been really embracing Switch from the start, right? And it's the form factor is so amazing, right? You can have this beautiful looking game, you know, in your hands with controllers, right? With the Joy-Cons, and it just plays really well, right? We're also really happy with how it looks, right? It's a high-end look, right? You have all the effects, all the super cool rendering tricks and all that.
And this is the same experience.
It's the same experience, right? The same game. So we update Fortnite every week almost, and Switch will now be part of that update cycle, so yeah, we're constantly enhancing it and doing new cool stuff, and giving this to players. So we hope it's gonna be really successful on Switch as well. We're super stoked internally in the company. People are super happy about it, and they're all like, yeah, this is gonna be my go-to platform, because after this day of work I can just play in my bed and not disturb my family or whatever. And it's we hope it's gonna be huge. So
well, hopefully it'll make it a little easier for folks if you want to keep up with, like, you know, popping in every day, coming in every week, checking for updates, take it on the go, you know, play it however you like. Can we talk a little bit about crossplay?
There's crossplay between PC, Xbox One, mobile, and Mac right now. And if you have friends on those platforms, you can play together.
And I don't know how much we can talk about it yet, but I do know you guys have some other Switch functionality in the works.
Yeah, so, you know, we've been super hard at work doing this thing, right? It's always the challenge of announcing something and going live at the same time.
Yeah.
So it's always like, oh, it's crazy.
A little bit of a rush.
We are basically focused on that. So make sure that, you know, the game runs amazing. You know, we have amazing visuals both in both modes. And, down the line, right, it has a touchscreen. So, you know, what can we do with the touchscreen that's meaningful and all that? So, you know, those are the kind of things we're going to explore kind of down the line and see what kind of cool things, we can give to people. You know, especially just in the front end, it's easier to use your finger as a mouse, right? That's clear. But, you can play with Switch in so many different ways that, you know, you might not have to have the touchscreen, right? So it should be an optional thing. So it's going to be interesting to see how many people will play, like, handheld versus, like, docked, and, that's one of the things that we're working on. And I think another huge thing is that we do support party voice through the headphone jack. So if you have a headphone, a microphone and headset, you could just plug it into the headphone jack, and you can talk with your friends on whatever platform they're on. So it's actually, it's huge for Fortnite to be able to communicate with people.
Yeah,
right?
When you're in a squad.
Communicate with your squad, right? I see my kids just talking to each other constantly, and they win the matches all the time because they're just about communication and teamwork and all that. And so this has been a really big driver, and we were able to get this out there. So I think at this very moment it's turned off, but we'll turn it on Thursday morning.
Awesome.
So yeah, we're excited about that one.
Yeah, can't wait for that and hearing more about these other updates that you guys have got in the works. Since we're hopping into another game, though, I did want to ask you guys your personal favorites when it comes to weapons, because one of the challenges in Fortnite is you have limited inventory space, so getting in there, deciding, okay, what gear am I going to bring with me in terms of weapons, what are your go-tos personally?
So for me, I'm a big fan of sniper weapons, whether it's the scoped assault rifle or the hunting rifle is a personal favorite of mine, because it allows you to still get that long-range combat but not lose your situational awareness, because it doesn't put you into a scope when you're zoomed in. It provides such a high opportunity for reward if you get skilled enough to use it. So that's my personal favorite.
So, Ariane, how about you?
Yeah, I'm always a shotgun guy. I've made games for a long time, and I always play shotguns. So I'm still that. I like the gratitude of eliminating somebody up close and personal. So.
And another great offensive option you've got here as well is traps, which we haven't really talked about yet.
Right. So we have a number of different trap types. Some are used offensively, or some are used more sort of situationally. So we have a damage trap that you can place on floors or walls or ceilings, and if somebody walks into it, they'll take a lot of damage. So if you're the crafty sort of player who wants to build sort of an intricate base or play a little bit more stealthy inside of a building or something like that, you can place it right underneath a ceiling or right beyond a door. Somebody walks into the room and takes damage, and then you can finish them off. We've also got some more tactical traps that are like a campfire that allows you to heal if you stand near it, or a launch pad that allows you to launch into the sky and redeploy your glider. Although you can see,
and sometimes you just want to dance.
Sometimes you just have to have a dance party. And this is just so much fun, right? Because you know, somebody could very easily just pick them off right now, but they're still having a fun time.
And maybe they'll just come up and join the dance. Yeah, I love that, you know, hopping into Fortnite, I never know what to expect, what I'm going to see. It's such a different game every time you play, and you really never know. I mean, everything from where you decide to land to what you decide to prioritize as far as, like, am I going to really, like, bunker down here? I'm pretty confident that this place is going to be safe from the storm, or you can do a lot of traversal, and there's so many different structures to explore as well, and, you know, just wondering, okay, you know, what's my game experience going to be this time? And chances are you're going to see some stuff you did not expect, no matter what you do.
That's right. So right now you can actually see that they're playing a 50v50 match. And in the top right, you can see, so there's a blue 48 and then a red. I think that's a 49. And so this is one of our really exciting modes that pits two teams of 50 against each other. And it's got some slightly different circle timings so that you have a little bit more time to gather up loot. But what happens is it eventually forces this combat in the middle between two gigantic teams. And you see these really cool build-offs, these great bases, and this sort of chaotic gameplay that, you know, we think Fortnite is so much fun and really able to deliver on. It's really cool to see teams work together in such a large format, and we've been really excited to watch some of the strategies that evolve there.
Yeah, it's fascinating when you get to the end of a match, and sometimes it's almost like abstract art sculptures.
Yeah.
And it's just amazing to see what people can come up with, and the folks who get really good at building on the fly and building very quickly, it's incredible what you can do as far as defensive work, traversal, and really just you're going back and forth like combat construction, and it's a very seamless experience.
Yep, that's right. So building is a huge part of Fortnite, and using it, like I said, for mobility, for defense, for offense, using it for all different kinds of things is exactly what we really want to encourage. So it's a big part of the game.
So another question for both of you, just wondering, for folks who are watching who are maybe thinking, okay, I'm going to bite the bullet, I'm going to jump into Fortnite. Do you have any advice for folks who are going to jump into their first match? Some tips and tricks for...
You know, I think actually 50-50 mode is a really good mode to start, right? You know, the first people you encounter are probably on your same site, right? Because you're basically the map is split in half. So it's you have more opportunity to just find stuff and exchange stuff and see what other people are doing and build really good forts and all that. So it's a really friendly mode to start with, instead of like solo or squad based modes where you have to have friends, right? So that's great. And you know, I think another thing is just as well. Sure, there's these super hot spots where you can go and there's a lot of action happening, but I mostly just try to get as far away from everything as possible and just, you know, chop down all the trees and find all the stuff and just really be loaded up. And then when I encounter something, I have somebody I can have all the building structures that I make and all that. So, you know, there's many different strategies, right? I've seen people just glide forever and they wait until the storm circle is like smaller and then they land. There's so many ways to play it. It's really fun.
So one thing we should touch on here is because it looks like I think Nick just picked up a golden suppressed pistol. So we have a rarity system in Fortnite that kind of indicates the rough power of different items. And so it starts with white items being generally the weakest, green items being a little bit stronger, white being common, then green being uncommon, blue being a little bit stronger, that's considered rare, and then purple is our epic, and then gold is our legendary. And so these different rarities kind of indicate how powerful something is. It's not an exact science, but it's roughly speaking, the gold weapons are better than a white weapon.
Yeah, especially as you're starting out, that's a good indicator. Just go by the color system and you'll have a good sense of maybe this is something I should hang on to.
Exactly. Generally, they'll be a little bit stronger, or they'll do a little bit more damage, that sort of thing. So really keeping track of the different types of weapons that you have and their different rarities is something that's great for keeping track of when you're a new user. In addition, just understanding kind of the basic building mechanics, just learning to build a ramp and getting up, you know, to the top of a building. It'll make it really quick for you to be able to get around the map and try different things.
And I think we'll keep in mind as you get started as well, like fall damage is something you want to take
right.
into account
avoid.
If you're really building up high. Gotta watch your step a little bit.
That's right. So there is fall damage. So, you know, if you build up too high, you can take a little bit of damage. That's in order to basically make it so that the building is a little bit more balanced so that you can't just build up to the sky with no risk.
I'm looking at, say, building cover. The moment you put something up, it's got a little bit of resistance to it. It's going to get stronger as it finishes construction. But if you're in a really tight spot and you just need to throw up a wall for a second to give yourself some breathing room, even if it just went up, it's going to have a little bit of protection for you.
That's right.
So getting used to flipping back and forth and saying, okay, at the very least, like, can I put a wall in front of myself real quick if I need to? Give myself a second to think about what I'm going to do next.
That's right. Yeah, and that's a great way to sort of defend yourself. You see some people build a one-by-one box if they need to bandage or heal up. You can see here Nick's kind of using that for a little bit of a defensive structure. So what you'll see a lot of times is if you shoot someone or do a little bit of damage to someone, they'll very quickly build up that defense so that they can assess the situation.
And there's some other interesting strategy we could talk about, especially looking at squad play. So maybe as far as your item loadout, what you decide to keep and what your teammates decide to keep, you could really mix it up when you know, okay, we're going to be working and operating as a unit. We don't all have to cover all the bases. Maybe we're going to specialize a little bit as we get into the game.
That's right. So thing that we really love to see is when you've got a squad of people and someone maybe takes a little bit more healing items, because that means the other people have more inventory space to carry more weapons or utility things. Or maybe someone will carry more explosive weapons like a rocket launcher, and then you can share explosive ammo with your teammates, and kind of that strategy of, okay, well, I'm going to carry that this round, or maybe I'll carry a different weapon next round, and kind of getting that whole teamwork aspect going.
And sometimes strategy is just, okay, you get to be bait. Go out there and draw some fire for us.
I'm usually that person. So you can see one of the other really great things about Fortnite is we allow you to spectate other players after you've been eliminated. And that's really important for us because we like to think about the game as not so punishing that, you know, it feels like a frustrating experience. So by being able to observe potentially the person who eliminated you or your teammates through the end of the match, that gives you a way to still experience what exactly is going to go on and how it's going to finish.
And it's a great way to learn as well. So I know we're getting a little low on time. I kind of want to just keep hanging out and playing, but do you guys have any final words for folks who are watching, fans of the game, maybe new folks coming in?
I've been running with this project for some time, right? Super happy about it. We're gonna give this to our other developers, so everybody that's using Unreal Engine can use our latest Switch thing. So that's gonna be great. I hope to see a lot of more Unreal Engine good-looking games on Switch. So you know, plugging that a bit, but we share everything that we find out with our developers. So third party, so that's great.
Yeah, and so, you know, one of the things that's so important for us on Fortnite is just continuing to update the game, provide great experiences for our players. That means, you know, weekly updates, weekly changes, including new items, you know, map updates, map changes. Really making sure that the game feels like a living, breathing world that's evolving and, you know, never feels stale. That's so important for us. And, you know, we're going to keep doing that as long as we can.
Well, thank you so much again, guys, for coming by and hanging out with us. I know you got probably a very busy day ahead of you, but it was great to have a chance to show off a little bit of what this game can do on Nintendo Switch. And hope the rest of the day goes well for you as well. But folks, you're watching again. This was Fortnite Battle Royale on Nintendo Switch. It's in the Nintendo eShop right now. It's free, so I would recommend going to check it out. I'm very excited to jump into this game as well now that my Switch is loading up for it. But thanks for watching, and please do stay tuned. Up next, we're going to be taking another jump into Super Smash Bros. Ultimate and taking a closer look at the Inkling. So please don't go anywhere.
Hey guys, welcome back to Nintendo Treehouse Live at E3. I am Morgan. With me, I have down at the far end Sam, Rich, and Eric Smith, who is going to be giving us an in-depth look at the freshest new fighter in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, the Inkling.
Yes, this is going to be a deep dive, so to speak.
Yes.
But basically, before early in the morning, we kind of saw Sakurai go through Inkling a little bit, but this is going to be a deep dive. We're going to look at each individual move and see how exactly Inkling functions in those capacities. So let's do it.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. So we are gonna be going to Final Destination. And I'm gonna go ahead and pick Inkling. Let's go.
Yeah. I'm going all the way up to Mario here. Yeah. Whoa.
Oh.
Settings, man.
Well, we're not actually fighting.
I'll be default.
Yeah. My bad.
No, that's cool. We're good. We're good.
Jump the gun a little bit.
You're gonna punish me anyway, so.
That's true.
I can blame my settings now.
So, Inkling is all about ink and ink consumption. So you really have to learn how to manage your ink. Inkling's neutral B is going to be the tried and true splatter shot. You can see Mario's actually been covered in ink here. As he is covered in ink, he's going to take more damage from all sources of attacks after he's actually inked. It's going to wear off after a while, but for now, that's when you want to actually try to unleash on him. And then you can see at the bottom of the screen near my character portrait for Inkling, you have the ink tank, and I've actually run, not run out of ink, but I'm low on ink. So I'm able to use some more moves, right? But now I actually am too low on ink to use certain moves. So I can't actually throw a splat bomb right now. That's what happens. So I'm actually very vulnerable at this time. What I need to do is get somewhere safe and recharge my ink, because I'm not gonna be able to do stuff like use my ink brush or any source of ink. So I can use this now, but it's not gonna do as much damage because I don't have ink. So I'm going to recharge by holding shield and then pressing B, which is your special button, and then fill my ink back up. So that was the neutral B, was just a splatter shot. Then we have the roller. So I love this move. So basically, the roller is going to move across the stage, and it's going to bury any enemy that hits it. So basically, what I can do is set up some really cool combos, cancel it out by pressing B, and then just punish with a smash attack. Obviously, the longer the the higher the opponent's damage is, the longer they will be buried for. So once you get them up to like 60%, you can kind of do this, cancel, boosh, and then smash them right up.
Boosh!
Boosh! And then you can see as Inkling moves through the ground, or through the environment, its dash actually turns into a squid. Because those of you who have played Splatoon know that Inklings are these life forms that can switch between Inkling form and squid form at any time. So going back and forth, I'm going to be doing that. And then actually my up B recovery, super jump straight out of Splatoon, you're going to do the exact same thing, turn into an ink, blast off into the sky.
What I love about that move is, like, do the up B again, because it does a little damage right on the front end, and then also right when you land.
Yes, I love that. So basically, that ink is not just for show. It's actually inking you up, and it's doing damage and knockback. And then let's go to the splat bomb. So the splat bomb, you can kind of just tap it and lob it straight up in the air, or you can hold it. That was backwards. Hold it and go long distance. Then you can go like in between, hold just a little bit. It's not going to go quite as far.
Oh, my recovery is way off. I'm at 155.
Yeah, something that Sakurai-san mentioned this morning also is the indicator that's on the ink tank. That, just like in Splatoon, that's how much ink is required to throw a splat bomb.
Right, yeah.
I am covered.
And then, so obviously the smash attacks is the ink brush.
Boosh.
Is the forward smash. The down smash is going to be your slosher. And then the up smash is going to be hold on, where is it? Come back, Mario. Up smash is going to be your blaster. Boosh. And you can actually, so that hits in front and then kind of puts them up top, and then you can blast them with the blaster right after that. One last thing is, so this roller, as I'm rolling, it's actually, you can see, putting ink on the ground. Enemies are going to move slower through this ink when they try to run through it than they would be able to normally. So you actually can use that to, you know, create some space for yourself and then do this, because you know they're going to have to run through that ink to get to you, too.
Yeah, which is really like Splatoon. It's like you're putting ink everywhere, and that ink is, whether it's coming out of your move or your weapon or on the stage, it's affecting your enemies.
Absolutely. And speaking just like Splatoon, you can see I'm booyahing here in my taunts.
Booyah.
Yeah, booyah, booyah.
Booyah, booyah.
Which is necessary, so necessary. All right, cool. Well, that is a quick link at Inkling's moveset, so let's go ahead and let's fight. Let's fight for real.
But I just want to get my revenge right now, but I know we got to change over characters.
We do. We need those controllers right
over
there.
Okay, so we got to couple controllers coming in while we switch game
yeah,
modes.
So as you guys noticed, Rich was Mario there just kind of getting beaten up to show some moves, but they're going to now go Inkling versus Inkling and actually play a little more seriously.
Where I get legit beaten up instead of just for demonstration
purposes.
Yeah, I mean,
Eric's still probably going to win, but
we'll see.
It'll be a little bit more competitive.
Yeah, I haven't been maining Inkling a whole ton.
Why? Why is it stuck?
we don't need to worry about that yet.
There we go.
Oh, is this the one? Yeah.
That's the one.
Got to swap over. There we go. All okay, right. Now we're ready.
We are going to go to...
Oh, this one's nice and cool. It's not warm for my hands yet.
It's sweaty and all right. Moist.
Moist.
Don't say that. Okay.
Inkling v. Inkling, right?
Inkling v. Inkling.
All right. So who do I want to be here? You pick yours, and then
yeah, you can see the different colors, and each color isn't just the ink color. They've got a different sort of set of gear that looks familiar, I think, from Splatoon.
Right. Kay.
Eric's got that skull bandana that I think a lot of Splatoon players are familiar with.
There we go.
His
now
boots.
I'm ready.
Moto boots,
knows,
I think.
Inkling's all about the gear. You know, you got to look fresh when you're smashing.
Ooh. Purple's cool too, though. No, I'm good here. I'm good.
All right, you good?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Oh, this is gonna be bad.
It's going to be fun.
Nah, it's going to be fun for you.
This is for the World Championship of right this second.
Okay.
You got a taunt.
So booyah.
I get a couple taunts in
all
there.
All right, yeah. One of the things that Eric was touching on
was
a little
fast.
Bit earlier.
It's just not cool.
Like, just like Splatoon, when you have a full ink tank, you feel like you have all these options. You've got the splatter shot. You've got the splat roller. You can throw splat bombs.
I don't
but
want that.
Just like in Splatoon, if you're not managing that ink properly and you run out, that sad, slow, dry roller. And it's really embarrassing.
This is just really not cool.
What?
Why are you getting everything? I'm going to use that to kind of come back onto the stage.
I'm going to need a
you know, I'm just
going to
hide down here. You do your
are
thing. Because I don't want to fight you. It shouldn't be this way.
Ooh, we got a new item up in the house.
Oh, God.
You pick no!
Do it!
Oh,
yeah. Oh. That didn't work out the way I thought it would. That could have been a lot better. Oh, I was going to go for the grab.
Okay.
No, you don't want that. You don't want that. Going to paint you down. Oh. Not cool.
I will take it.
I really was hoping I'd be able to get in there with the paint before you... I'm just going to shoot.
Nope. I'll take it.
Wow, nice grab. And nice air dodge. And nice total failure to dodge. Oh.
No!
I really appreciate that. Very
right,
kind of you.
I'm going to prioritize dodging this over...
Oh, nice.
That hurt quite a bit.
Oh, why am I going to run into that? I am very into items, but not moving fast enough for my own good. No, Smitty, why? Why do you have everything? Oh, I'm out of ink, too. That's terrible.
Yeah. That was the sad roller I was talking about. The sad, dry
you
roller.
Do move. Oh, come on.
Yes.
Well, that's
oh,
just...
flawless victory on my part. I did an amazing job of not shooting you in the slightest. Here we go. Oh, yes. Get in my hook.
And Eric, you probably spent the most time with the Inkling. Do you feel like this character like reminds you of anyone else's playstyle, or
come
do you feel
on.
Like certain,
oh, no, I don't want to
certain strategies?
Do
or,
it. You know, because you have the ink management, it is kind of
an all new.
It is kind of all new.
Don't
I mean,
slow me down.
Oh, that's bad.
Oh, except I missed completely. That's good. My panic mode is not helping exactly. Not doing me any good here. What I'm really good at is like just totally choking in the moment. I think that's one of my key skills here.
Why are you doing this thing? That's my middle name, actually. Choking.
Yes. Land near me. Oh. Oh, that's me over there. Wait. I lost track of myself. I'm letting the panic get to me. The panic is not good. I don't want to be in there, though.
Please get in there.
Okay, I'm taking a deep breath. I'm relaxing. I'm going to roll right into your shot. Okay. All right. I'm just going to reset myself here, throw the bomb in the wrong direction, and...
Ooh, it's an Alolan Raichu. New Pokemon. We'll talk about
that's
all
fine.
The new items in
Smash
Death
Ball,
later,
Smash Ball, so. Smash Ball, Smash Ball.
Someone's I just got to stop Smitty from getting that. And I got to not
the
lose
Smash
track
ball.
Of myself here. I'm not quite tall enough. I missed it. Okay.
Somebody
well,
please.
I'm just going to not worry about that then.
You're not going to bother with it?
It'll be back.
That's bad.
I don't want that right now, and I don't want you to have that either.
That's not helpful.
Presenting only the most embarrassing and painful matches I can find.
And I'm asleep.
Oh, this is great. Aw. Man, the hubris got to me. The totally unearned hubris, I should add. No, I really want to not die here. I think I'm just going to die here, though. Nope, we're good.
Oh, okay. Nice. You so do need to refill your ink up, though.
Yeah. And I'm still inside the blast radius. I thought I was going to hover just outside of it. I don't want us to die here.
What I love about watching you guys play is, like, there's so much Splatoon in the Inkling character. Because you've got so many of those different weapons from Splatoon. You've got the ink. You've got the super jump. You've got to refill your ink. They packed so much Splatoon into just one fighter.
They did. It's really impressive. And as we saw earlier, the final smash is the killer whale from Splatoon 1, which is always fun.
I don't want bees.
Bees!
I don't want bees!
Okay.
Oh, no.
It was a plan. I had a plan for a minute.
The bees saved you!
The bees saved you!
Bees. Okay, I do want bees. I love bees. Oh, God. All right. Got it. No. Why are you a samurai gold? That was supposed to be mine. Ooh. And you've got a little Bomberman out there. You know what? I'm going to.
I love seeing the fully inked assist trophies.
The fully inked Bomberman, too.
Smitty, please. Smitty, no.
I'm sorry.
Smitty, it doesn't have to be like this. It's going to be like this. Oh, gosh. All right.
Okay.
And that went as planned.
Hey.
It was close.
It was a good fight.
It was close-ish.
It was all of those things. Yeah. That was great.
That was fun.
Good job there, Smitty.
Hey, I think Bomberman actually wins that one.
Yeah, Bomberman MVP for sure.
I'm happy I got three. I'll take that.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so that was a look at Inklink 1v1, but why not double down on that and go Inkling?
Inkling. V.
Four
Inkling,
Inklings.
V. Inkling.
V. Inkling. And a new stage, I think.
Yeah. Let's do that.
Okay, so there's
we're gonna
there's
need to
three
change the
words for you.
Set
got four?
Real quick, like, it'll be just a moment here while we do this.
We're just trying to find controller four.
Okay.
All right, we're reaching for controllers.
We're gonna reach for controllers. Hold up.
We're getting this figured out.
We've all got controllers now. I think this one's mine. They all aim at the right system. Okay.
Yeah.
So a series of Inklings of various skills and abilities.
Yeah.
I'm going to put my money on me not beating Smitty.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I'm excited to see tonight, because later tonight we've got the finals of the Splatoon 2 World Championship and then the Smash Brothers Invitational. And I wonder if anybody will use the Inkling in the Smash Brothers Invitational.
Yeah. We're just about set up here.
Okay. Let her take it out. Yes. So, as you said, Morgan, one of the coolest things about Inkling is how you have all this Splatoon sort of stuff wrapped into one character.
Yeah.
And with all the different colors of ink, especially, I don't know if you guys saw in the intro or the direct today, the eight player Inkling light. That was like incredible.
Yeah. So you're going to see a bit of that chaos up here. You're going to see all of our colors on the field, and we've got controllers. So
cool.
There.
Let's do it. We're going to jump in to Moray Towers.
This is going to be our second chance to get a look at Moray Towers, but it's going to be all Inklings this time around. We've got all characters. I've got player four. So you know what? I'm going to pick an Inkling whose color matches. No, I'm not. They all got claimed.
Wait.
Someone's random.
Wait.
Don't go random. There you go.
Hey, Smitty, do you want to change to a different color, and then I'll be green, and my character will be green, and my thing will be green?
You know, just because. Yeah, I would love to do that.
That way we'll all kind of match. We'll be like a nice palette, a nice range.
Yeah, this is close enough.
Yeah.
All right, cool. We ready?
Yeah.
Let's do this.
Okay. I'll deploy all the... Did I pick my name? I did pick my name. Oh, good.
You did.
Whew. Yeah, we all did.
I mean, it's spelled wrong. It should say loser, but it says rich.
It's that way on my birth certificate, too.
Are you guys taunting? Did you guys taunt?
Oh, I didn't taunt.
I'll do two taunts in recompense.
Oh.
My favorite thing about this stage is that Judd and Little Judd are just dancing in the background.
You know, they're kind of off duty.
I'm facing the wrong
this
way.
Game, so.
One of my favorite moves of Inkling is actually the forward air, which is this drop kick. It has actually really good clearing potential.
Oh gosh, the dolphin nearly got me there.
With Inkling,
oh
you know,
my gosh,
you really have to find moves with good clearing potential and just really.
It's gonna take a moment to ink up
because they don't all have great clearing potential.
You know what? I'm gonna kind of go after the people who are fighting and sneak up. That's gonna be my strategy. Is I'm gonna come up behind you when you're not looking.
I think I've spent about 50% of this match half buried in the ground.
Hey.
Get him.
Oh, he's got the thing. Oh.
So, Eric, do you think that Splatoon players knowing about ink management will have a slight advantage at first with
oh,
the
no,
ink
banana
fighter,
gun?
Or
you know, drop the banana gun?
I think that's certainly a possibility. I mean, you don't have to worry about turf management except for that roller, which you can use to slow down enemies.
Smitty, I'm coming. Oh.
One cool tidbit is that, so when you've inked someone and then someone else inks them, like if I were to ink Morgan and then Rich, you know, begins to ink Morgan, that piles up. So if I ink him up to 50% and then Morgan inks him up to 50%, or you know what I'm saying, then that's when they'll be at 100%. They will change color ink, but it doesn't matter who's inked you, you're still going to be taking damage from all sources.
I jumped right into that too.
I feel like I really need to stay away from Smitty.
I am seeking him out to see how many KOs he can get against me. There we go.
I KO'd myself with a barrel. That was a Donkey Kong death.
I'm going to go for that. Oh, and I'm going to get hit in the back.
Somebody get that smash ball.
You guys don't worry about it.
Oh, no.
You don't have to worry about a thing.
That's bad. That's real bad.
You don't have to worry about a single thing here.
So you can actually aim that final smash, and you can actually set it and forget it. So once you do that, you can actually drop it and then join the fight, kind of jump right into the killer whale itself and start hitting them while they're being pummeled by that.
And you still have a degree of control over where the beam's going, too.
Correct. So healing cure.
Oh, I'm getting in there.
I love
heal me up.
Item.
Heal me up. Stop taking my healing.
It's like King of the Hill in here.
Hey. Anyone gonna jump into that for me? Nope. All right. Yo. There. All right. Maxine.
When you're playing four players, it's really hard to find a safe space to be able to recharge your ink. You have to kind of get away.
Oh, I jumped right in there.
Inkling is kind of like a kind of like a hit and run sort of fighter where it's like you need to get in, use all your ink up, and then get out to recharge.
Oh no. Oh, here comes the items.
Oh.
More items.
Yeah.
Yes.
You might notice one of those assist trophies there. We got our boy Knuckles.
Oh, goodness gracious.
Oh, I missed. Whiffed it. Oh.
All right, about a minute left here. Please. Ooh.
Oh, no.
I'm going to use that.
Do it.
Oh, no.
I'll take it. No, Sam got it. Sam doesn't deserve it. Oh.
Hey, come on.
Oh, that was kind of cool.
Let me see that you got splatted.
That was worth it. Is that legit, or am I making a big mistake?
I think it's a real one.
It's legit. I don't want it.
No.
Oh, come on. Someone. All right, I got Morgan.
All right, fine. For the sake of TV.
Ow.
Oh,
that was a few.
Voiced by my own. Oh, get in there.
Get in it.
This is chaos right now. So you can actually, you might notice we're on Moria Towers here at night, kind of reminiscent of what it would be like to be in a splatter.
Did you get taunting out there?
It is not always like this.
Who's got the thing?
Oh, no.
That is,
I don't want the thing.
Three, two, one. Time. Hey. What? Inkling
oh, man.
One.
Inkling one? Who would have called that?
Man.
I was not nearly as terrible as I expected to be.
Hey,
same here. All right.
It worked out. You know, we have time for another match, so let's do it.
Yeah. So,
Morgan. A button.
Hope so.
Yeah. Yep.
We are going to have an animal mascot showdown.
Yeah.
It's like the animal kingdom basically going
at it. Yeah, because the Inkling is, you know, a squid. So why not bring in the other furry friends or whatever?
And no better place than that than an Animal Crossing stage, right?
Animal Crossing stage, but no villager here. Not in this match. So I am going to have to pick someone else. I'm going to go DK.
I'm going to go with Fox.
And I'm player two this time around. So let me get my name. Pick a palette. Ooh, yeah. I'll go classic DK.
Let's do it.
Now you have to also speak in your character's voice the whole time.
Wait, no, that's
Shy Guy.
My burnout that works. Burnout might throw on day one. Wind it up.
Come on, Sam.
You're fine.
Yeah, custom age. Yeah, all
that's
right.
Great.
I'll take a beating.
I really appreciate your generosity, your kindness.
That was quick. Oh, see? You deserve that. You taunt at first.
I am going to. Oh. Hey.
So one thing that's really cool about Inkling is that you can actually execute the side B in the air and land with it ready to go.
Oh, gosh. Okay. No, I don't want to be in the ground right now.
Gracious.
Do the wind up.
Crystal.
The stage is too small for Sonic.
Crystal's not making things any easier here.
I
no.
Monkey, no.
Someone.
Oh. Ow.
Takamaru.
I can't even tell who's murdering me right now. All right. There. A little moment to breathe, and Smitty's not giving it to me. Ow.
Sorry.
It's okay. Got my invincibility for just a few seconds here. And there's bees again.
There's always bees.
Oh, I underestimated where you're going to land. Guys are going to blow up here.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, come on. Hi.
You need to get better at using the splatter shot. It's great at stopping people in their tracks, like Sonic, but rolling at you, because it fires so quickly.
Hey, Sonic, I got you something. Oh.
Ow.
I'm just gonna go over it.
Oh gosh. We're just gonna sit over here and eat.
Just gonna wind up. You guys do your own thing out there. Don't worry about me. I'm just do a little midair wind up and come here. Oh,
goodness.
Morgan trying to snipe me with a Fox's laser.
I like to use the laser, just kind of stand back.
Why did I run in front of that? Hey, I got one too. I thought I was going to get that. No, not you, not you.
Good.
Oh.
Neutral B.
Don't let him do it. He's doing it. We're all in it.
Yes.
Okay. I think I dodged it, actually.
That is a
you dodged it.
Final smash. Oh, well played.
Sonic had the speed advantage on that one.
And I'll get in a cheap punish.
Take this.
Metal squid.
Lasers?
Metal squid.
Hey, metal squid.
Wow.
What is going on out there?
It feels kind of humiliating when you get done in by the roller.
Coming back? No, I thought you were coming back.
I'm trying to knock out some other brain.
I need the points.
We don't want that.
Oh, man. That'd be some real damage, I think.
Smitty, did you get that tomato?
I did not. I'm still super high damage right now.
Ow.
Oh, gosh.
Oh, my. This is bad.
Goodness.
Okay. Stop it.
Nope.
And,
never.
All right, Sonic, we got words.
All right, 2023. There's still time. A couple more KOs.
I am
playing? Oh, okay. In time, you really have to prioritize.
Ooh,
once it gets down to like 30 seconds, kind of like in Splatoon, huh? You have to figure out who you're going to go after, essentially.
And I am now
trying to secure that one last KO.
Nope.
Like Donkey Kong, discharging.
just going to float away.
So we're kind of winding down last minute of this match. Smitty, any last things you want to mention about Inkling's moveset or things you're excited about on this fighter?
It feels really fresh, you know, because you really got to think about that ink management. It's a deep fighter.
Try to get rid of Midna, too. Oh.
As I mentioned, it's kind of a hit-and-run sort of fight style, and Inkling's very maneuverable, so we got to use that to your advantage.
Yeah, and that's really similar to what Chao Splatoon plays. You know, you get in, you get out, do what you can while you have ink, fill it back up. I feel like it's also a fighter that's just fun to have in a match. You've got ink everywhere, it's more colorful.
It just seems wrong.
It's a party. It's a party with the Inkling.
I'm still winding up.
Nope.
Ah. What is that done?
No. I am still alive.
Come here. I got distracted talking.
No. Oh. Get him! Get him!
Come on!
Oh, he's so heavy.
I live. Taunt.
Who has it?
DK!
Yeah. Nice work.
Well played. The dirtiest victory.
Nice.
Minus seven. Well, at least I got my smash.
Hey, man. You know?
It's fine.
We're all casuals. Okay.
All cool. Right, well, then. Thank you, guys. I think that was an awesome look at Inkling, one of the two new fighters, the freshest fighter, as we've said. Mm-hmm. And that's about it for this segment. Hopefully, you guys have enjoyed that. We're going to be right back with Overcooked 2. So stick around for that, and we'll be right back.
Awesome.